Oh, yes.
Oh, this is a great way to start off the show.
There you go. My bad. That's it.
Yo, what is going on, everybody? It's your guy, Snowbike Mike, back again with another Monday morning to kick off your week. Of course, I'm joined by my friends, Nick Scarpino, Andy Cortez, and Kevin on the ones and twos. Andy, I'm going to start with you. What up, big dog? How are you, homie?
I'm doing fantastic, Mike. I'm in that mode right now where I don't know if I want to start off the day with an apple or not.
Oh, you should. You should, Andy. Let me just answer that for you. You should. Go for it, bro.
Andy,
man,
Andy,
real quick, consensus from everybody.
Yeah,
what's going on?
Yeah, yeah.
What kind of apple?
This is a... let me double check.
Let me see that bad boy. That, is it green? Is it going to key out?
How are you going to chop it? You just going to bite right into it? You going to chop it?
No, I don't savage. Want to chop. Fucking savage. Chop. Bite right into it. Are you kidding me? I use my fucking God-made chompers.
He's got, Mike, I don't know if you noticed or not, but all these little things in your mouth are little knives.
Why is it taking him so long to get this apple out?
He's wiping it down. He's making sure it looks pretty.
What's the name say on the sticker?
Because I washed him, and I don't want, like,
what's the name say on the sticker?
It's a Fuji.
Fuji.
Oh, Fuji. Oh, nice.
You can eat the sticker.
Yeah. They say that, but I've never looked into it.
Do you think so?
You know?
Yeah.
No.
They're edible.
No.
You can poop it out.
They say that, Nick. We should look into it.
Mike,
Andy,
I believe
eat the sticker
believe
right
this...
now and tell us if there's anything that bad happens to you.
Okay.
Eat the sticker. Eat the sticker.
I'm doing it. Don't do it. Don't. You know better than that. Don't you know you don't want it.
I think this chicken's. I think Kevin's right, though.
No, I just looked into it.
What if a baby bites into this with their gums?
Why are you giving a baby a fucking apple? They can't hold that thing.
Well, okay, it's like you throw a baby into the deep end, see if it'll learn how to swim. You give it an apple, see if it knows how to eat an apple.
It's true. You give it a whole pumpkin, see if it knows how to carve it.
For the first 6 months, they hold their breath.
Shut the fuck up, for real babies.
Inhale water.
Yeah.
Babies know how to do that?
Yeah, that's a trait that's like inherent. It's like hardwired.
I think it's because they're sitting in a big thing of amniotic fluid.
Oh.
Yeah, because they also, for the first 6 months too, every time they see food, they try to eat it through their belly button.
Oh, wow.
I always wondered how them babies didn't drown in the body.
Because they hold their breath for 9 months.
Fuck.
Like a bear. Like a hibernating bear.
Bro. Anna Cortez, to stick with you before I move on, I was also asked by the team and yourself to check in with you each and every week. Anna Cortez, how many salads have you had this weekend?
This weekend? Well,
this
I had
weekend,
one.
Because, last week was supposed to be somebody else's job. I'm here to start off your Monday, so I check in on your weekends.
Thank you. I had one salad over the weekend, but since the day that I asked the people on the Kind of Funny podcast to ask me, that was about maybe a week and a half ago.
Okay.
I've had about, I think, 9 salads since then.
Wow, that's solid. That's very solid.
This is why I'm excited for Andy to eat the apple, because I do worry about the overall nutrition of Kind of Funny.
Oh,
some people eat more healthier than others.
A good crunch. That was a good
and
crunch.
I feel that was a really good crunch, Andy. And I feel like it's important that we be encouraging good nutritional value food going into each other's bodies. In addition to, of course, Andy, all life's about balance. So while you're eating that, I'm going to drink this nice red apple Coke Zero here.
Red apple?
Yeah.
Super concerned about it.
Just to balance, Kevin, just to balance it out. You know, for every one of us that works out, someone's got to sleep. Yeah. Someone's got to hang out.
Nick.
That's where we're at here. Kind
of
funny.
Nick, let me tell you, you'll be so proud of me. I was about 3 hours into a fundraising stream on Saturday, and I'm going through Elden Ring.
It was like $200, right? Good.
Yeah.
For shit.
I get towards the end of it, and I'm like, I thought I had beaten the final boss, and Elden Ring says, no, here is the final boss. Mm-hmm. And it's the most hype thing of all time, where they bring around the intro song, but kind of speed it up a tiny bit and remix it in a way that makes it even more epic than before. You're like, I didn't understand how epic this could feel, and I'm feeling it right now. And as soon as I died, the first time, I'm excited, first off. I'm filled with glee, and I'm just like, oh, man, strap the fuck in. I'm going to go get a Cherry Coke Zero from the fridge. My first instinct was like, we are going to beat this right now, but also I want to feel Cherry Coke Zero all around my mouth. And, that's the first thing I did was, go get that soda, pop that open. It was so cold and crisp. Oh, my gosh, what
Andy,
a night.
No matter how good life gets, it's only ever at 95%. You got to have something to push it over 100%, and that's where Coke Zero comes in. And lately, a lot of people have been like, every time I drink a Coke Zero in front of them, they're like, wow, those are really bad for you. And I know, I get it, man. But every once in a while, you got to live on the edge. And by every once in a while, I mean 5 to 6 times a day. You got to get that edge. You got to see where that edge is.
Oh, also, Gory Oreo says more maple Pepsi. I decided to try out the maple Pepsi.
How was that?
I'll look for a clip.
Yeah, I'd like to know what your reaction. Because when you said first off, when you said it was Pepsi, I was like, that's gross, non-starter right there. And then you said maple, I'm like, yeah. I don't know if I think that the maple, because like Coke in general, not Diet Coke, but Coke in general is kind of like liquid caramel, right? It's got that sort of like caramel flavor to it. I don't know that I need caramel with maple on top of the caramel. That might be two flavor profiles that are so close that they make your teeth hurt.
Yeah, it was not what I was expecting, and that's my fault because I should have expected what I got, and I was quickly like, ew, this is not good.
Like, yeah,
it was not good at all.
It's like vanilla. It's like vanilla Diet Coke. It's too much of a good thing. The Diet Coke itself, the Diet Pepsi itself, the flavor profile is already perfect. God came down. Touched Diet Coke Zero on the boop boop my hair, Andy, right on the nose, boop boop, and said you're perfect. And then adding anything on top of that is just like it's like rubbing it in the face of Pepsi. Mm-hmm. I don't even know why this turned into a bitch fest about Pepsi.
I apologize
to everyone out there that's a Pepsi fan, but you know who you are and you know what you've done.
No, fuck them. You know what I mean?
Not exactly, man. I mean, I was trying to be nice to get out of here with your. Is Pepsi okay? No, it's not okay. It's never okay.
Let's keep it going, of course. Nick Scarpino, let's check in with you. You had a nice weekend. You went and got away. How was your R&R weekend? You feeling good?
Yeah, it was good. I just snuck away for a little weekend away with my wife. We hung out. We ate a lot of chocolate. It was very, very nice, very relaxing weekend. And then we came back and recorded the Academy Awards, and nothing really happened in there. Nothing happened
to talk about. We're not going to talk about that. Yeah. Nick. Question for you. I don't know did you watch episode 4 of Winning Time yet?
No, I did not.
Okay. So I want you to know.
Still.
They go to Palm Springs.
Love Palm Springs. We're going to go there.
It's Palm Springs in the, you know, what is it, 70s, 80s? I don't know what you call it.
I think
it's. Let's just say this, Nick. It's hot, fresh, lively. And that's why. That's what I'm imagining your and D's vacation was. You went to the pool, and all of a sudden it was super sexy. It was like the Playboy Mansion, is what it looked like on the show. That's what I imagine you guys have.
We mostly just went to Starbucks, but that's cool. That's cool, okay. Too. I did, however, start watching a show called Minx, which is another HBO Max original, which is a really, really good show. It's our friend of the show, Jake Johnson, is one of the co-leads in it. But the star, and I forget the actress's name right now, is the woman that played Karina in Guardians of the Galaxy.
Friend of the show? Would you call him that?
Jake Johnson?
Yeah,
he wore a T-shirt once.
He wore one of our shirts. He wore when you've donned.
He wore a Nerf Alice shirt. Yeah.
Well, you know, if Nerf Alice is out there thinking that, you know, she can get away with this, away with Jake Johnson without giving us credit for this.
No. We sold the shirt, right?
No, I don't think we ever sold
the T-shirt.
No,
never got
we
sold.
Never sold the shirt.
No, that was Nerf Alice. Right. That was a Nerf Alice original. But we did send it to Jake Johnson.
Yeah, that's
did give us props. For sending it to him. So actually, now that I'm talking this out, it's possible that we stole that shirt from Nerf Alice and gave it to
Jake
Johnson.
It's what it sounds
100%
like.
100% credit for it. Yeah. Now that I'm thinking, now that I'm like working it out in my brain, Kevin, delete
don't
the
do
archive.
Don't do that too loud.
Yeah, because Nick wanted to go extra defiant on that.
If we could,
now
good
that
show,
I've thought
though,
about it rationally for 1 second.
That's all it took.
Let me backtrack.
Just a couple of seconds of critical thinking is all you needed.
Listen, Jake Johnson, friend of the show, best friend of mine.
Yeah.
Stars as a, it's like a late 70s show about the main character is a woman who wants to start a feminist magazine, but she can't get funding for it because all the people that give her funding for it are like old white dudes. And so she finds the only person that'll give her funding is a guy that does a lot of porn mags. So he says, we'll let you write in your voice. We'll let you write basically all these stories, but we have to basically hide the medicine. And the way they hide the medicine is by making the first ever nude magazine like geared toward women. So it's like naked men, and it's Andy, a lot of dongs.
A lot of dongs.
Wow, a lot of dongs.
Okay. There's just a slideshow of dongs.
Wait, what show is this?
It's called Minx. It's not based on anything. Service? I don't think it's on HBO Max. It's really good. It's really funny. It's very clever. I forget the actress that plays her sister, but she's fucking hilarious. It's a great cast. It's just, it's my new favorite show alongside Winning Time.
Minx.
What's that?
Oh, just in the chat, Mal13 says, Meats?
No, close Minx. Enough. Close enough.
Very close, very close. You typed that in.
That was fun. Winning Time. Yeah, I got to get back to episode 4 of Winning Time.
Yeah, we'll talk about Winning Time in just a second, of course. But first, I got to catch up with our guy on the ones and twos, Mr. Kevin Coelho. Kevin, how are you today, big dog?
I'm doing pretty good. Pretty good. Getting some dirt picked up, waiting for it. Hope everything goes smoothly.
How many big bags you got out there? What are we talking? 3, 4, 5? How many did you really get?
8.
8 of the big yellow bags are out there on your sidewalk right now.
Yep.
Kevin, impressive. Great job, big dog.
How many children could fit in that bag?
Children?
Oh, you could probably fit 15 you can children put,
I mean,
the
are
bag.
They are they laying on top of each other? Like, are they dead or alive?
No, standing straight up. Whoa,
standing straight up? Well,
wow.
But like, they're like kind of roll the right and pack them in like you.
Well, okay,
like,
yeah, but you're not gonna do that.
Like tamales in a little igloo.
Let me tell you, if you start out with living kids and you do that, by the time you get to like the third level of them, that first one is not, he's not doing well.
I'm shocked that like, because Kevin's usually the one who stops us from going places like that.
He went there.
Well, I'm just saying, like, yeah, because like, let me, you can stand, you know what? 12.
How many Nick Scarpinos could fit in there?
Ooh, dead or alive.
Why? Do I weigh less dead? Am I smaller dead?
He's claustrophobic. Well, you're claustrophobic, so maybe 3. We could put 3 Nicks sitting next to each other.
Oh, shit, so this is big.
Yeah.
Oh, they're massive, bro. They're massive.
Oh. Yeah.
Can we get a shot of them for Andy here? Can we get
dead,
a shot?
Dead. I mean, I don't know. I've pulled it up
before.
You
can dig. I mean, I'm like 185 right now. I had a couple of
I feel like I could fit if Nick was standing inside.
It's 3,000 pounds. Each one is 3,000 pounds of dirt.
Oh, shit.
I could probably put 12 to 15 Nicks in there.
Yeah, you can get 12 to 15 Nicks in there.
You know what I'm saying? No, I mean, if you had dead Nicks, you could probably put, maybe 10. Well,
because you can bend them easier and stuff.
Yeah, exactly. They fit. They're not complaining. It's like watch my knee. Watch my knee. You know,
it's like that. You guys didn't watch Reacher at all, but there's a shot in Reacher where he has to put 2 bodies in the back of a trunk and they don't fit, so he just snaps one of their legs. He just snaps them back. Like,
oh wow,
because he's such.
I don't think
man.
I could do that.
He's a big man. You could do it if you had to, Mike. You could do anything if you had to.
No, is that the? Is that the non Tom Cruise version?
Yeah. Correct.
Yeah. No.
That castle.
This is the Alan Richardson version that was an Amazon Prime show that was actually pretty entertaining.
It's so funny
it's ongoing.
The first season's over. Yeah.
It's so funny that when you talk about that show, because I didn't know that it was such a big controversy that Tom Cruise was hired for that role.
Well,
in a way, it like pissed off a lot of the hardcore Reacher fans because I listened to a Dan Levitard podcast where they advertised this show. And the script of it was very much like, hey, this time around, Reacher is big. He's a big, muscly dude.
Fucking and like, Andy, let me tell you.
But it was just so weird to hear an advertisement be like, no, this time around, he's what you think Reacher looks like.
Yeah.
Don't forget the last version of him. This time, he's big and muscly, and he means business. And I was like, what a weird way to sell your show. Like, it just sounded so odd.
It's one of those things where it's like, if you're like, listen, we're not getting any new people to watch this show. We got to preach right to the converted on this one. So let's just tell the 15 people that read these books that this is going to be exactly what they want. Now, to be fair, the second Jack Reacher movie was hot garbage, but I stand by the first Jack Reacher movie as being an entertaining film. And I don't think that you necessarily needed a man of Alan Richardson's. Anyway, Thad Castle's stature, but it does help because he's fucking looks huge in this show. It's pretty cool.
All right.
Kevin, to follow up with your bags really quick. Kevin, when you line them up across the sidewalk, are they all in one straight line, or do you have them like Tetris style, like 2 here, 2 behind it, 2 behind that? Because I know the guy's going to pull up in the crane and pull it all up. Like, because you can't take up the whole block because then everybody would have their cars there and stuff. So what'd you do?
What'd you do? I have them set up in 2 rows. Okay. And with a gap in the middle. You've been like by my house. You know that
I've seen it.
There's like a lot of sidewalk. I have like a normally large amount of sidewalk right in front of my house, you know? Instead of the traditional like what people have normally like 6 feet. We got like 15 feet of sidewalk.
Now, question for you. Did you have anybody come help you?
Yeah. I hired people to help.
Oh, wow. You hired people. You didn't get Andy to come down with a shovel and offer him an apple?
No. It's like after doing a bunch on my own, I was like, I can't ask people to. This is the kind of thing that breaks you
at that point
physically.
You show me an apple, I'll show up.
Show Andy an apple.
I would bet money that there's nothing Kevin could do. There's nothing Kevin could entice you with to get you to show up and help him pack dirt for an entire day. There's nothing he could give to you.
No, Andy would do it. He'd step right up. What does it take, Andy?
Did I tell you what ended up happening when I'd failed two bags in a day?
Yeah, your back hurt because it's a lot of fucking work.
Well, I mean, my back wasn't too bad. No, my ear bled.
Yes, he did say that. His ear started
bleeding. Right. Which really scared everyone. The doctor said it was fine. You know,
Paula thought it was over.
And if we're talking...
Which is why I was like, all right, well, maybe I'll hire people to do this.
And Nick, so what you got to understand about this is, you know, if the world's strongest man goes to lift weights and then, you know, his whole stomach, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
What do you expect from a normal person like me? Like, if Kevin's ear is bleeding, imagine what that will do to me.
You're going to be bleeding out of everywhere.
Everywhere.
How do you know?
Every hole.
Yeah. Every. And I love that you said that through a mouthful of apple.
Yeah.
You didn't stop eating the apple or chewing the apple with that, which tells everyone out there everything you need to know if you're hiring Andy Cortez Dirt Moving Services. That's not going to go well.
I'm glad he's eating the apple to start the day.
Eating an apple on the job.
We have a lot of fun stuff to get into, but let me tell you about my weekend, of course, to start off with my favorite segment. What did Mike buy this weekend?
Oh, Christ.
I bought shit.
Kevin, I thought we agreed to take Mike's credit card away from him.
He's a bought shit.
We can't. He's so slippery.
A long time ago, there was this awesome super sexy, stupid sexy Flanders toy that came out. I bought it. So that was a long time ago, as many of you know. It was a long time ago. And I had a dream a couple months ago. I was like, man, did I buy that super sexy Flanders? What happened to that? And sure as shit, it showed up this weekend. But not just one. I guess I bought two. I don't remember buying two, but I have two now.
What are you going to do with that? How much was it? Was it affordable?
Oh, it was expensive, Kevin. These are expensive toys.
What are we talking about? Well, they're not
toys. We're talking like $120 a piece.
No.
Oh, my God.
No.
Yeah, probably $120 a piece. $120.
You're fucking with
buck
me. 50. Yeah,
you know what? Mike, here's what we're going to do. We're going to start figuring out a legal and simple way to use all the shit you buy as giveaways and reimburse you for them. Because somebody in the chat is willing to debase themselves for one of these sexy Ned Flanders statues, and you don't need two. As you were saying this, I look in the chat, Soul Porpoise is like, why two? ? And I can feel the frustration.
Because he hit the button twice, I guarantee you.
God damn it, Mike. You put quantity two by accident. You didn't know. You got to stop taking tarantulas to the forehead.
Then I got another package, and I said, well, what is this, right? I don't know what this is.
I
opened it up, and it was a box of Golden Grahams. And so to whoever out there sent me a box of Golden Grahams, I say thank you.
Now, that was me. I sent you that box. Because the other day we were talking about how Mark Ellis put what he put that picture of the cereals and said, what two cereals are you walking away with here?
Golden Grahams is so good.
You said you had never had Golden Grahams.
Never once.
And so I thought, what a travesty. I'll send Mike some Golden Grahams right now. Amazon primed them to you. Turns out you can get Golden Grahams delivered to you faster than anything else on the planet through Amazon Prime. They were like, do you want this right now?
2-hour delivery. Yeah.
So, Mike, I'm excited. I actually want you to taste some of these Golden Grahams on camera right now.
Yeah, I'll do that.
And I want you to tell me what you think of your first taste of Golden Grahams. Everyone, this is a historic event. Pay attention.
Mike will
the Hindenburg.
Well, here's what I imagine, Nick. I imagine that Mike will buy a Toyota Corolla from the Toyota site, and then two will show up, and he won't realize he bought two. He'll be like, oh, well, I got two of them now. There will be no process to actually send it back. Let's see. No. Let's see it.
Oh, okay.
Is he one of these kids that eat it dry?
Eats his cereal dry? We don't need him to pour a whole bowl, but he does eat dry cereal, yeah.
Oh, God.
What's wrong with dry cereal? What's wrong with that?
Come on, you know what's wrong with dry cereal. No. Don't make me yell at you.
There's nothing wrong with dry cereal for a little snack.
I mean, okay, but like only eating it dry because the wet is soggy?
I'll do it both.
I know, but Mike won't.
Now, Mike, the Golden Grahams, when you first taste it, is a weird taste. You don't know if you like it or not, but then you find yourself eating more and more of it, and that's the power of the Golden Grahams.
I feel that. Yeah. I feel that. Like, I'm consumed by that right now, actually. Like, I want to just keep eating this, my hand in the bag. So at first, you open it up, right? You take a big whiff. It smells like graham crackers that have just been beat down into a cereal form, right? Yeah,
that's exactly what they are.
And then when I look at them, I'm like, oh, they look kind of like Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Will there be a little cinnamon drizzled on top of this, right? And I grab it. No, they're just dry flakes here, right? So then I was like, oh, now I'm disappointed. But then you bite into it.
I'll tell you the thing. It's the crunch. It's got such a good crunch.
Oh, my God, see, Andy. It's the crunch with this little bit of just roast, like toasted honey on top. Mm.
Listen, Cinnamon Toast Crunch and Golden Grahams are like the Hemsworth brothers. Where at first you see Cinnamon Toast Crunch, you go, it's obviously Chris Hemsworth, right? And you see him. But then you see Golden Grahams standing next to Chris Hemsworth. And somehow you didn't even realize this, but Golden Grahams is taller than Chris Hemsworth. I lost this metaphor. I lost this metaphor halfway through. I don't know.
So did I. It's okay. It's okay there.
You know, I haven't had cereal in years, Nick. Like probably over 14 years now. And so this is a big deal. This is a big deal that you put me onto this. It's not Cocoa Puffs, not Reese's Puffs. These are good. These are good.
You haven't okay, so like you haven't even been to somebody's house where it's like, oh, they got cereal. I'll eat cereal. Like
Andy, I haven't been to another person's house in years.
Mike hasn't left that room in 45 days. He's still in Chilates delivery.
I thought you were going to say 45 months because I would have believed that.
I remember when we first started, when we first started the company, it was back when it was just like the five of us sitting at Colin and Greg's place. And I used to, me and Kevin would catch me just stealing cereal from Greg's cupboard. And I'd be like, you shut the fuck up, Kevin. You shut the, he'd be like, put me a bowl.
and you would bring your turkey and some mayonnaise.
Yeah, I just would make turkey and Brussels sprouts, and I'd open it up, and Kevin would be like, dude, you can't do that. You can't be fucking bringing Brussels sprouts into this house, bro.
Oh my gosh.
That's what I'm excited about for the new studio, Kevin, is what kind of snacks are you and I going to sneak? And we have the Tree of Trust. Because every once in a while, Kevin used to come around the corner of the old studio, and I'd be housing Oreos. And Kevin, to his credit, would never say, he's like, I'm not going to fucking say anything because I know a man's shame when I see it.
All right. So I have two more things and then we got to get into it. So first off, Kevin, Nick, and Andy. And Andy, this is more directed at you because you and I are very similar, right? We're in the comfort zone. We're in the bubble. We have everything we need within an arm's reach, right? But I'm trying my best, as we talked about for 2022, is to get out of the bubble. Right. Go out there and try new things, whether it be fashion, whether it be food, like eating some cereal with all of you. We're just getting out of the house
cereal
and exploring.
Getting out of the bubble.
It's a big moment right here.
Huge.
And so what I did was I took a drive. OK, I finally got out of the bubble. I took a drive and I said, you know what, Mike, you're going to go. And mind you, here's a little setup for everybody. The place I went is less than an hour away. The place I went, I haven't gone to because I've lived here in this spot for 13 years and never found the need to go. But I finally went to Virginia City, Kevin, which is an old gold mining town right on the outside of Reno and Carson City. And it's this fun little spot, right? It's like this just like old-timey Western cowboy type vibe with a lot of gold mining in mind. And so I went and took a walk around Virginia City and it was a blast, Kevin. It was nice to get out of the house and push myself to adventure. So I took some photos for all of us to look at. This first photo, of course, is of the high school football field. And Andy, as you remember last week, we talked about the most iconic sports venues around the globe, right? And this one took my breath away because look at this small little place. High school's got 12 kids in it, but look how big the football field is. They got 12 kids.
They're playing 3v3.
They're so tired.
So they move the fence when they want to play football?
What'd you say, Kevin?
They move the baseball.
To play baseball on the football field if they need to. But
and that happens in real life too, Kevin.
Oh Yeah, remember Oakland had that, Andy. Oakland had that.
There's some football stadiums that convert into baseball stadiums. Suddenly, the baseball game happens, and there's like mounds of dirt in the fucking like you're running over. Yeah, it's cool.
Somebody writes in the chat, no stands, lol. If you look very closely on the left hand side, there's one set of black bleachers. Yeah, there's
one set of bleachers right
here. One set.
You only have 12 kids. You only need what, 24 seats?
It's premium seating, right there.
Premium.
Mike's gonna pay $200 for those seats.
Oh my god, that's so funny.
And so if you keep going, Kevin, of course, walking down the main drag, you have all the touristy spots that you like, but this is the shot of the main road right here. Just kind of old school.
Where is this again?
Well, it's called Virginia City, right outside of Reno and Carson City, about an hour away from Tahoe.
This is super cool.
And it's a cool vibe right here. And I got a good story at the end, but Kevin, if you keep going, I started walking into some of the old timey bars, hotels and restaurants, and I took some photos of some of the bars, like the Bucket of Blood, which you're going to see in just a second. The Bucket of Blood Saloon had a very interesting one because they had dollar bills on every piece of surface and then bras hanging from the rooftop. It was very, very weird. It was a weird look.
weird is a way to describe this, man.
Yes, exactly. And so if you keep going, Kevin, there's some more shots. I took some shots of all the different bars here. But
why is that one lady dressed in colonial garb?
Okay, so there was about seven ladies and gentlemen that are walking on. Nick, there's this one guy in a full-on, like, sheriff's outfit with a shotgun standing in front of the local hotel opening the door for people. And I was worried that it was a real shotgun.
Yeah, it probably was.
I was a little worried there.
You're
so
in Reno.
I'm hoping he didn't have a real shotgun there. You know? Yeah. And so, you know, some old-timey bars and restaurants there, Kevin, as he keeps going through. But there was one spot, and I actually wrote Matt Rohrbach about it. So, Nick, you know at all the different touristy spots you've been to, there was sell different knickknacks.
I like the idea of you writing an actual letter, though, like penning a letter to Matt Rohrbach.
One of them, you know, as they sell, like, the gemstones and the jewelry, and then there's a toy shop. There was one place that only sold posters. And if you look at this bar, imagine this bar times two building size. And it was nothing but posters, anime posters, kids posters.
That's cool.
Then they had, Nick, original theatrical release posters. And so what did I do? I paged through 10 different piles to find Point Break, to find freaking all of the old school 80s movies that we watched. And they are super dope, bro. So
that's cool.
Just wanted to take y'all on a little trip to Virginia City.
Why didn't you take any pictures of those?
I was gonna, but then I was like, do I do that? I should have done that. Security guards. I felt awkward, but I didn't.
I'm shocked that a town like this, which seems to be very of its time, right? Like this city is trapped in a different century.
1975.
Yep. I'm shocked that they are aware what anime is. Is that weird to say?
Oh,
no. There's got to be one guy that grew up there that was like, I figured out what this thing called the internet is and
went against the norm.
Yeah. Everyone else is like, we just want you to stay in this town and spend your hard earned dollars in that slot machine. That lady was crushing right in that last picture.
I like the idea.
Slot machine too. I could have guessed that.
Oh, Mike. No. We told you to stay away.
I'm banging that button, Kevin.
We told like you not to mess with those buttons.
I like the idea of Mike just going to small cities and just vlogging. Just being a little travel vlogger, you know, like going to these small hole, you know, what are they called? Hole in the woods?
Hole in the wall.
Hole in the wall. Neck of the woods. You see what I was doing there? These small towns that maybe aren't big in population, but they're big in heart.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it would be cool to see Mike kind of just adventure there. See what other football field and how many stands they have. You know what I mean?
Just check in on the same five things every time they go.
Mike's like, what is this football field?
What is the size of your football field? 15 people? Wow.
So here's a good one for you, Andy. I'm coming to see you this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, right? And I was so excited. And I'm in this adventurous mood, right? And so I was like, okay, what do I do? Do I go to Six Flags with Kevin on Sunday? Or do I hop in the car, wake up really early, go to Big Sur, California? Nick, turns out Big Sur, California, Central California on the coastline, below Monterey. Mm-hmm. Very far than I thought. I thought it was just a little quick upward. No, it is down south, so not going to Big Sur.
Big Sur is like 3 hours away from me, from San Francisco. Mm-hmm. 2.5 hours, 3 hours away. But I will say this, Mike. If you've never been to Big Sur, it is arguably the most magical and coolest spot in all of California.
Big Sur, the S-U-R, right? Big Sur.
Yes,
I think. What is that? Let me guess. Okay, that's either a tidal wave, that's either a mountain or a canyon. Mm.
I don't have no idea. I have no idea why they named it Big Sur.
Mm. Oh, but really?
It's a mountain, right?
Is that a mountain?
Is it a mountain? I thought it was just a big coastal city, probably massive waves, right?
Well, that's the name of the city, but I don't know why they named it Big Sur.
I thought Big Sur referred to the mountain.
That sounds about right.
But I mean, Chad, I'm sure one of you guys might know.
All right, here we go. Big Sur. What is so special about Big Sur? It has been called the longest and most scenic stretch of undeveloped coastline in the contiguous contiguous. Yeah. A sublime national treasure that demands extraordinary procedures to protect it from development. One of the most beautiful coastlines. So it doesn't seem like it is anything. It's just kind of an all-encompassing thing. But it's not like you would walk to a mountain and you go, wow, look at that. That's the Big Sur, you know.
It's just. But it is a section.
Oh, well, because Sur is south, Kevin. The Big Sur. Yeah.
So T. Sweens in the chat says, the name, quote, Big Sur is derived from the original Spanish language El Sur Grande, which translates as Big South, or from El País Grande del Sur, the big country of the south.
País del Sur. But
no. I will say this. I've only been to Big Sur twice. And every single time I go down there, I'm like, this is a place. This is like... It just feels like a special place. Like you know how certain places have energy that you're just not used to when you're from a city or just anywhere that's been developed. You go to Big Sur and you're like, this is actually, it's crazy because you'll be inside the forest and you'll think I'm in the mountains. And then you'll just walk down the street and you're like, I'm at the beach. This is the weirdest fucking place on the planet. And it's trippy to think that all of the coastline used to be that until we decided to develop it. But highly recommend you go there. Most of the hotels are prohibitively incredibly expensive, so you're going to probably have to sleep in your car. But everything else is beautiful, and there's like all little artist communities and places all around it.
I don't know that I've ever been there. I think I have because just my family would go everywhere. But is it that different than the beauty that is like, you know, that coastline south of Pacifica going to like Monterey?
It only is because you have like thick forests. So you have like redwoods down there where you walk into the redwoods, you're like, holy shit. It looks like if Muir Woods was right on the beach.
Sure.
Which I
sure,
think you
sure,
can probably
sure.
find a spot of Muir that might be.
Yeah, I think
but it's
so
hard
too.
To find it without a bunch of houses there. It's pretty it's pretty true. And it's not to say that people don't live there. Like there's obviously communities and like houses and stuff. It's just for the most part, you can find like just incredible pockets of nature and the shoreline's beautiful. And even the resorts that they built into there, a lot of them are like still pay.
Yeah.
Respect to that. Like there's a couple that I wanted to stay at, but they're too fucking expensive. Where they built the rooms into the side of the hill.
Oh, that's
insane, grass grow over them. And I was like, oh, that's cool. And then I looked at the price. I was like, nope, I'll stay at the Motor Inn.
Sounds like they might have bugs there though. I don't know.
They're gonna have a lot of ticks probably, which is great because then you know for sure Greg's not gonna be there. And that's a priority in my life.
I'd love to go to Monterey in the aquarium.
Yeah, so Monterey Andy, aquarium. I'll go to the Monterey Aquarium with you anytime, bro. Then we can even go further south. And we can go to Carmel by the Sea, which I like to call Carmel by the Sea, a place I would like to live because that place sounds fancy as hell.
Carmel is fancy, and Monterey is great. And Monterey has the little which ones, Kevin? Which ones are the sea dogs that crack shit on their tummies?
Otters.
Otters. They have otters.
Yeah.
And the otters now, in
the sea dogs that crack shit on their tummies.
You brought up a good one. You brought up Muir Woods. So now, depending on how much margaritas you, me, Andy, and Kevin have on Saturday night. If not, I'm going to Muir Woods on Sunday morning. I'm going to get out there before everybody, probably around 8 to 9 a.m., go send it there, then drive back up home.
That's a smart idea. I will not be joining you because you will not be doing that. We're going to get hammered. There's no fucking way. There's no way you're waking up, A, early in the morning on Sunday after Achievement Hunter Live for 4 hours, during which we have to do 5 minutes of work, and I will drink my weight. In tequila margaritas on Rooster Teeth's dime. I will do that this weekend.
Oh, okay. Like
for everyone that's in the Bay Area, if you didn't know, Achievement Hunter Live is happening this weekend, April 2nd, over at the Fillmore. I'm sure they're sold out by now. So me telling you this is useless, but just maybe you can wait outside and catch a glimpse of Snowbike Mike.
Muir Woods like Endor?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's Endor. Have you been there, Kevin?
Yeah.
It's great. Good. It's super cool.
Yeah.
It's weird to walk around and be like, that's where he crashed the speeder.
I've never been there.
Oh, I went camping there one time, and it's just like, I mean, I wasn't like where they shot it, but I was all of it looks the same. So you're just like, oh shit, this really does look like Endor.
It's cool. Andy, if you want, Mike will not be going next Sunday. You can not go with him.
You can pretend not to go with me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mike, bring down those golden grams, though, bro. Let me get a little bit.
Okay. My final two for everybody really quick, because we got some more fun stuff to talk about. One was, of course, Winning Time. I want to bring back up Winning Time. Winning Time, episode 4, awesome. Spring training begins, and it is so awesome to see Magic Johnson smiling alongside Kareem, right, the captain, they call him. And he forces the rookie to bring him orange juice every morning. What a great storyline with that one. A lot of fun. New coach in here. Who the is McKinney? And it's an awesome episode. This episode really starts to ramp up the fun. And I'm all for it, Andy Cortez. I hope you're watching this.
I watched episode 1.
Okay.
Loved it. Haven't watched episodes 2, 3, or 4.
They're not doing a great job promoting it. I will say that. I think that HBO, for some stupid reason, does not have confidence in this show. And I see it
on Twitter a lot.
Do you? Good, because they need to be splashing this everywhere. It's to the point, and maybe it's just because there's so many shows out there that I just feel like I keep finding shows on HBO specifically that are like these little hidden gems. And I'm like, I don't understand why more people aren't talking about these shows. Like, Minx is a perfect example. I think Minx has like 2 seasons already. I've never heard of the show before in my life. And I'm like, wait, there's like 12 episodes of this show? What the fuck's going on? I watched the Bridget Everett show, which they did promo a little bit, but I really liked that show. Somebody somewhere, I think, is what the show's called.
Who's Bridget Everett?
She's a comic.
Okay.
She's a comic, and the show is like fairly serious. It's a dramedy, but anyway, it's just a perfect example. Like HBO, Mike, obviously, I respect people like myself, where I could just go on the podcast and I don't have to tell people how fucking great I am, right? Yeah, I don't need to tell. I don't need to keep reminding Andy and Kevin that I'm the best that the sport has to offer.
They show up.
I don't
up,
have to keep saying that. I just show up and I do my thing. And that's what HBO is doing. But every once in a while, you got a mic. You got to toot your own horn. Boop. Give me the apple.
Toot it a little bit.
Just toot it a little bit, you know?
Can I toot a horn really quick, Nick? Please toot a horn for Andy? Bridget Everett, Andy Cortez, let me set the stage for you. It was a nice, beautiful summer night in Tahoe. Amy Schumer was coming to town. And you know me, on a drop of a dime, I'll go buy a ticket and I'll go see a show, right? Because I'm bored. I got nothing else going on. So I forced my buddy, I think it must have been B-Ball and Brian, to come with me. And B-Ball and Brian was like, no, Mike, this is going to suck. And I was like, please, you got to come with me. We show up, Andy. Let me just set the stage. Giant outdoor arena, probably sold 1/8 of the arena. Nobody wanted to see Amy Schumer, unfortunately. But here's the catch. Her opener was Bridget Everett. This lady is hysterical.
Badass.
This lady is so good. She has comedy. She sometimes gets up and sings dumb songs. Andy, she invited a man up on stage and proceeded to sit on his face and sing and grind his face into her private parts. It was epic. It was incredible. And I said, I want to see that lady again. It's a must see.
I saw her perform. First off, people are correcting me. Yes, there are only 4 episodes of Minx. I was thinking a different show that had 2 seasons we were going to start watching, which looks very good.
So I was thinking of Seinfeld.
No. I was thinking there's another show that we queued up that was about it. I don't think it was an HBO Max. I think HBO Max just bought it. I think it's a British show about someone, a woman that hooks up with a guy, doesn't realize he's like a huge star, and then dates him for a while. Anyway, it looks cute too. I saw Bridget Everett at Clusterfest like 4 years ago, and I had no idea who she was, and she blew the fucking roof off that place. Was it outdoors? Yes, but she was on the outdoor stage, the big stage outdoors, and she sang and she danced and she did comedy, and she just had this wild energy. And I was like, this woman is everything I want to be as an entertainer and more. And when I was like, oh, I like Bridget Everett. I started watching her show, and it is like a sincerely heartfelt like show about someone who's just fucked up and like needs to find her way back to some semblance of like goodness and normalcy, and moves back to her small town in Kansas. And it deals with a lot of like difficult issues. But man, I got to the end of it. I was like, this is a really good fucking show. Really, really good show. Really subtle show.
Toot your horn, HBO. Toot it.
Can I toot my horn one more time? I'm going to toot my horn one more time. So speaking about buying tickets that you probably shouldn't buy, but I'm going to buy this.
Here we go.
Andy, Nick, and Kevin, I also sent the invite out to Blessing because he likes to cut a rug like I do. T-Pain is coming to San Francisco May 10th, and that's a perfect birthday / like fun event for all of us to go to. And I thought maybe we could go see T-Pain in San Francisco. Let me know, because like I'm tempted to buy us all tickets and just force you all to come with me. But like, you know, I was thinking maybe we'd get up, like we'd get the tickets where like we're like not in the box, but we're not in GA down below, and we're not GA up in the top. But like, we all have our seats, and we can dance and stuff.
Like, T-Pain. It's T-Pain. We can spend no more than $25 per ticket.
Oh wow, okay. I was gonna spend $220 on each ticket.
No, you don't need to spend that much. We could do
$220.
I mean, it's T-Pain. It's T-Pain.
You could do $50 nosebleed sections.
Okay,
get still hammered have a before time. The show. Watch three T-Pain songs and be like, "We're good." We're going to leave T-Pain now.
Nick, right, we need to have a big meeting with Mike after this just about the IRS and kind of
listen,
like...
Andy, I'm the lawyers have been called. Mike's conservatorship is in the works. Okay?
Like, you are going to be... pay the credit cards back eventually, Mike.
Yeah, he doesn't know this. He doesn't understand how APRs work.
We're going to see T-Pain, everybody. So
they were just lending
down.
Me money. I don't know.
DJ Kento, thank you for those 10 gifted tier 1 subs.
Thank you to DJ Kento. Here's one as we move into now the stories of the week, because I have a special guest coming to talk with all of us. But here's the rundown. If we fill up the bar today, I will stream Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild after this stream for a little fun bonus stream. So if you want this stream to keep going, if you want some more Legend of Zelda with you and me, I will stream that later this afternoon if we fill up the bar. But let's keep it going right now, because of course we have to talk about the Oscars, and we're going to have some serious conversations here, because, you know, we're going to make fun of this. We're going to have some fun. We're going to talk about the slap heard around the world. But most importantly, I wanted to bring on Matt Rohr back to talk with Kevin, Andy, and Nick about the Oscars and, like, you know, celebrate the incredible human beings that made some great stuff over this past year. So I don't want to lose sight of the good, positive stuff that we should be focusing on. But we are going to focus on Will Smith smacking the shit out of Chris Rock. Yes. Can we turn that fucking thing on right now, Kevin?
Oh, you want to watch it now? I thought we were taking a more serious take on it.
We'll do that.
So we're going to watch the full clip?
We can just watch him smack him. I think everybody knows what's going on. You know what I mean? But let's watch him at least smack the man. Can I get a pause here? Can I get a pause really quick? We gotta frame by frame this really quick. Andy Cortez, look at this follow through. Okay, look at the follow through. It's like a perfect Devin Booker shot right here from the three.
It looks what it looks like, honestly, is a quarterback drill.
I mean,
it looks like someone just like following through with their throwing motion.
Uh-huh.
Again, strong stature, strong defense from Chris Rock. I think on both ends.
There's so much to unpack here. But one of the things that, look at how much bigger Will Smith is than Chris Rock.
Oh yeah, and I guess Chris Rock see that. Yeah, he's
barely took a step back when he took.
He handles
this.
It like a champ.
He fucking handled the situation
like a champ.
How hard
do you think that slap was?
I think it was hard.
That hard?
Really?
Yeah. It looked hard enough.
Hard enough to make him take a step back, like you saw. Now, at first, I thought, oh, they're screwing around with each other, because Chris Rock had his hands behind his back. So I thought, oh, he's putting his face forward like this is a goof. But the stuff that unfolded next, I was like, oh my God, this is a horrible set of circumstances that has just unfolded for the entire world to be watching right now.
And this caused me to actually turn on the Oscars.
Yeah.
And
well, me too, because I was, Andy, I had taped these because we were coming in late and I had Punchline last night. And my brother was like, texted me, was like, Will Smith just smacked the shit out of Chris Rock live on the Oscars. And I was like, oh, that's a funny goof. And he goes, no, not a goof. Sends me the clip of, I think, the one we're watching, which was not, see, in the American televised version, if you guys are watching in any other country, we didn't get, they cut, it was just silent while Will Smith was talking. It wasn't until I saw someone tweet the Australian version, failed to cut out what he was saying. And Will Smith this was not a joke. This was a very intense moment between two people. And I'll tell you one thing right now. I don't like this. I love Will Smith and I love Chris Rock. And I do not like that these two men have had a conflict. It makes me very, very sad.
Yeah, And again, enough for me to turn on the Oscars, and apparently ratings went from 9 million viewers to 17 million viewers in that short span. And then he won Best Actor.
That was the craziest thing. Wild. So I see this star popping, and I'm on my way to Punchline. And then my brother's like my only tie. I don't know why he's my only tie to the story, but he was like, oh my God, Will Smith just won and he's going back up. And man, that speech was a range of emotions. We'll just put it that way.
Yeah. First off, I think, and that's the thing. Like, that should have been the focus, and that's like the sad thing about it. the terrible joke, dude. Like the idea that you're making a G.I. Jane joke, like that's so old, and like that shows me that it is. I think if you're willing to make a joke that dumb and bad and just like out of date, that it isn't even topical. So many people don't even know what the fuck G.I. Jane is. And you make that joke and, you know, the issues come out and people talk about that she has alopecia and she's dealing with hair loss and stuff like that.
She's been
very
vocal about it as well.
Well, yeah, it's not something I even knew.
It's
but the
not
thing
something
is,
that
like,
I do.
The thing about it, though, is like, it'd be one thing if, like, Jada Pinkett Smith decided to tattoo her whole face or get something really like a Ben Affleck back tattoo, that type of thing that somebody wanted to make fun of and make a joke about. But like a bald woman is not anything rare to make. Like a bald woman exists everywhere. Like it's so weird to make a joke about a woman who has her head shaved. Like,
dude, so just for context, comparing her to G.I. Jane is not. Like the G.I. Jane, like Demi Moore and G.I. Jane was a badass. So I took that joke when I first saw it. I was like, I don't understand why people are mad at him. That's comparing her to like an iconic role that Demi Moore had that was about a very strong female, right? And she had shaved her head in that movie. It was a very iconic moment where she's like, I'm gonna fucking prove to everyone that I can do this. And so when he said that joke, I was like, oh, it wasn't until afterward I learned that she was suffering from a medical condition that I was like, that's a really bad look. Like that is not a joke that probably should have been made to someone.
Yeah,
does that make
but
sense?
Like
I don't think Chris Rock was making the joke. I don't think he was saying that to be like you're a strong woman. He was just making fun of the fact that she's bald. But like that's how I took it. But also, there are black women that are bald everywhere. There are women that are bald everywhere. Mm-hmm. It's just like it again. If she would have Mike Tyson tattooed like the worst, ugliest thing on her face or gotten something just really weird that changed her appearance entirely. But like a shaved head is so normal that I don't. It was a stupid joke to make in the first place that
is not
unfunny.
Yeah. Not the best Chris Rock joke.
Yeah,
we'll put it that
it's
way.
Really
not,
dumb. Yeah.
Not the best Chris Rock
but
joke.
But surely the response, I think, was unwarranted. Like that, like for him to walk up on stage like that is. So inappropriate, right?
Just think like how much he has gone through. Like at first, when I without context, I thought he went up there to slap Chris Rock because a comment was made about their marriage. Mm-hmm. I thought immediately without any context. I don't know what's been said because the muted version was the only thing that's happening. Twitter's firing off. I don't know what's happening. I thought, oh, he probably made a joke about how she has sex with other guys. That's the only thing that would warrant a slap, right?
I thought they both had like an open relationship. I thought I had seen that.
I think that's what
they do. Yeah. They do, yeah. But I thought Chris Rock was still kind of making fun of them for that. Mm. That's what I thought would have justified him going up and being like, "Don't fucking talk about my marriage, like,
right?
Fuck you! How dare you do that?"
Yeah. But I mean, even then, that still is unacceptable, right? Like,
I'm not saying you should fucking slap a dude on camera. I am saying that also, Will Smith. I think about like how the comment section will make me, I'll read a negative comments and be like, God, these people are annoying. The people that are negative about Kind of Funny. And then think about that level of criticism that Will Smith has been getting his whole life times a million, times a billion, million. And all of those sort of,
I mean, think about how
all of those sort of hits,
is, though, you know, like
Kevin, that doesn't matter. Kevin.
Oh, I mean, it absolutely like
Kevin.
I mean,
no,
it's so
dude,
much easier to be like,
oh,
like, ignore
come
the
on.
Hate.
No, Kevin, you can't say that just because somebody has money that they're like, oh, I'm rich anyway. Who cares?
I'm
no,
sure it makes
dude.
It a lot better.
Sure. Yeah. Being poor and getting a bunch of shit your whole life would suck.
Yeah, absolutely terrible.
But Kevin, you're like, we can't fucking compare what people are going through because of how much money somebody has. Like, they, you can't do that. Like, if someone's dealing with.
I am saying that, like, part of the dealing with, like, the positives of fame also come with negative. And the negative is people, like, regardless who you are, people talk shit about you, you know? Like, that's just part of, like, you're going to be made fun of. The bigger you are, the more famous you are, the more successful you are, the more you get, like, shit on at these kind of events where, like, people are ripping on the guess, you know?
Yeah. Well, I mean, look, the joke was in poor taste. Knowing what we know now, I think the joke was in poor taste. But I don't think that gives anyone an excuse to start throwing hands, personally speaking. I think there's better ways to handle that. And I look at it from two perspectives. And I think the one that a lot of people, you know, I've been watching or reading a lot of the comments. And honestly, like, I'm a married man. I understand that you feel the need to want to protect your family. And if someone insults someone that you love, like, that can be very, very difficult for you to deal with. So I'm not gonna sit here and say, like, you know, I don't understand where Will Smith's coming from. But I did, like, I appreciate my wife's perspective on all this stuff. You know, I got her perspective on it, and she was like, if you did that for me, I would be incredibly disappointed with you. Because it is not necessarily your place. It's not 1950, right? We don't have to have men stepping up and, like, defending the honor of their wives like they're some piece of property. Like, I don't think this is just my personal take on it. Like, if you feel differently, obviously, and you have a different situation, that's all you. But I wouldn't want anyone going out there and risking their hurting someone or potentially being incarcerated or getting in trouble with the law to protect my honor. And I think Jada Smith is a very smart, well-spoken woman that she could probably do that herself. And I just feel like the whole situation was terrible. And I will say this, I just don't think there's ever a reason that you need to resort to physical violence for something like this. I get where Will Smith's coming from. I understand all the energy built up with all the criticism he had taken, but man, you just walked up and punched a dude in the fucking face. Think about that for a second.
On one of the biggest, like, televised events that's just, of the year.
If I would have, if there was, like, a fallout of, like, some art that they got into a verbal argument backstage, and I would have totally understood that and been like, yeah, it's kind of fucked up for Chris Rock to, like, first off, make that stupid joke or whatever. Can we all just laugh at Judd Apatow saying that he could have killed him? Like, that was the funniest tweet after the fact.
What did he say?
Judd Apatow tweeted, like, he could have, like, Judd Apatow very against that Will Smith did this. And I'm not saying you should feel bad for being against the punch. Like, I don't think you should fucking slap somebody. Like, I think the only reason Will Smith stayed there is because he was he won best actor. Like, I think he would have been likely kicked out or escorted out in some way, because you just can't do that, right?
Yeah.
But Apatow tweeting out after the fact, like, Apatow was not happy about it. More so from the stance of, like, man, we're really not going to be able to make jokes as comedians now if, like, we have to worry about somebody coming up and slapping us. But then Apatow started off the tweet with, he could have killed him. It's like, he slapped the guy at Judd Apatow.
To be fair, like, this is what's people have a jilted concept of physical violence because of what we see in movies, right? We see people getting punched all the time in movies, and they get knocked out and they get right back up, or you get punched 1,000 times. It is very, very possible that if you punch someone one time and they get knocked out and hit their head wrong, that's it. That's a fucking real possibility that happens a lot. And it happens a lot in...
He slapped the guy.
But also, Andy, like, he fucking outweighs the guy by probably 30 pounds, man. He's a big dude. Will Smith's not small, man. You can't be going around throwing hands at people like that.
And on top of these guys aren't young. Like, Chris Rock is 57 years old. Like, I know that, like, I think when we think of Chris Rock, like, the image that comes to mind isn't a 57-year-old man, you know what I mean? And it's like, yeah, he slapped him, but, like, I don't know, this is very serious, yeah.
Yeah.
It's crazy now, that he didn't get removed, I think.
Yeah, now, I agree with that, too.
Yeah.
I will say, Chris Rock, I was like, I'm like, oh, my God, how is he going to handle this? Handled it the best possible way you could if Will Smith just slapped you on stage. Yeah. Was like,
yeah.
Let's just go to the nominations. Let's just go to that. And then here's what I feel really bad for. I mean, obviously I feel bad for Jada. I think that she's just been thrown into this situation, and it's like, Jesus Christ, why does she need to deal with this? I feel bad for the team, Questlove, and the team that won the fucking documentary after that and had to go up and do a thank you speech, knowing fully well that
your moment is gone.
Your moment's gone.
Yeah.
And, you know, I feel bad for Chris Rock, and I feel bad for Will Smith as well. Like, Will Smith's first Academy Award win, and probably his last, is marred by this now. It's a terrible situation that everyone was put into. It was handled poorly. And I just think it's sad. And again, I love Will Smith, and I'm not one of those people who's going to go out there and be like, I can't support Will Smith anymore. I'm sure that Will Smith and Chris Rock, well, this is what I want them to do. I think they need to get in a room and handle and work this out like adults, right? You can't. Why not? do it. That's what they need to do now. Like Puff Daddy said, or Sean Combs said afterward, he was like, they all need to handle this shit. Like, get together, your family. Get together and fucking handle this shit. And out of all people, I'm like, Sean Combs making some good fucking... Sean Combs, also a big dude, walked off stage. I was like, how tall is Puff Daddy? Is he throwing hands? What the fuck's going on here, man? What a weird night. All in all, dude. It was just fucking weird. And then, but that's not even like the weirdest shit that happened. The whole show was just a hodgepodge of really good jokes and really poor choices that were made the entire time. And I don't even want to start deconstructing this thing because it is just a rabbit hole to go down. But I will say this. I thought that the hosts, I thought Amy Schumer, Regina Hall, and Wanda Sykes did a great job. I thought they were super fun to watch. Amy Schumer had, in my opinion, the best laugh of the night when she comes back out and she's like, I was changing out of my Spider-Man costume. Did something happen? What happened? Like, the vibe changed.
Oh, yeah.
It was pretty funny. But
just,
yeah.
It just completely awkward, though. Yeah, totally. Like, I think that, like, if it's anybody but Will Smith, they get kicked out. Like,
oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
If a random dude in the audience gets up and slaps Chris Rock, it's an unprecedented moment in Hollywood that we've never seen before. We've seen people get made fun of and the camera cuts to them and they may not look happy and you go, ooh, that one didn't sit well with them or whatever. Yeah. But this is just like a moment that will go down in history as like, what the fuck is going on right now?
I know.
But yeah, the response from the like the actual Oscars like not pulling him off is, I think it's really odd because it's like, obviously if someone walks on stage in the middle of the nominations about to be like read out loud, throws hands and then yells off things, that sounds like that person is like not sober or something, you know, or not in the right mindset to stick around.
I saw videos afterwards of like Denzel Washington went up to go talk to him. And then I think I saw Oscar Isaac also talking to him.
What was that other guy? The dude from Limitless? What's his name?
Oh, Tyler Perry?
No.
Tyler Perry was talking to him.
Up there, though. Oh. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know if he's from Limitless. I never watched Limitless.
Bradley Cooper, that's it. Yeah.
I mean,
That was Bradley Cooper. That wasn't Oscar Isaac? Oh, shit.
I think so.
They have the same hair. I was like, I think that's Oscar Isaac.
They both have a great head of hair. It's unfortunate for me.
Yeah.
Yeah, what a terrible situation. Again, I feel nothing but just bad for just everyone that was involved in this all around. And again, I'm not, you know, it's really bad for the people that were winning that night, because I feel like this is all anyone's going to be talking about. And I do think there was some historic wins and some really good moments in the show. I think there were some painfully awkward moments also that I think this slap is unfortunately covering up. I don't know if you guys watched the Lady Gaga Liza Minnelli moment, but that was just a very, very awkward.
What happened there?
Lady Gaga and Liza Minnelli came out on stage to, I think it was Best Actress, and I think Roar Beck's here now, so he could probably tell me.
What up, everyone?
Yeah, let's introduce him right now. Of course, I brought on Matt Roar Beck today to join us because, you know, as much as we're going to talk about the slap and the world will talk about the slap, like Nick just said, there's a lot of great to talk about here. And of course, Matt always comes in with all of the knowledge to get you excited to watch certain films, get you at least in the know. And so, you know, Matt knows I watch movies on my phone, so I need him the most here to break this all down for me. So, Matt, come jump in with the gang and, let's talk about that and let's talk about everything, Matt. What are the things people should know about?
First off, I think you guys kind of crushed it with the discussion on the Chris Rock thing. Like, I know that's what everyone's going to be talking about, which is kind of like unfortunate. And I think you guys kind of covered every angle of it and then to Nick's point right now, it's just like, it kind of took the spotlight away from the movies and even Will Smith's historic win and different things like that. So it was just like I had an out of body experience last night. That's how I felt like watching this. Like, it just felt like since that moment, and Questlove was done so dirty too, like Nick said. And like from that moment on, I think it's all people could talk about. And obviously it's the whole discussion today. And it just made for like a really awkward kind of ceremony through and through. But then even then, like the show itself was kind of strange on top of that, even without that whole thing. But to Nick's point, like there was a ton of like great movies honored and great awards, like Coda winning Best Picture, I think is like a perfectly lovely movie and like a huge thing. Like Troy Kotsur winning Best Supporting Actor. That speech was so good.
You want to talk about Troy Kotsur was I forget her name, but the woman that won for Best Co-Star of Minari. who presented him the award, right? That was that moment, right? I could not stop smiling when her the entire time when she went up, she's so sweet and so like genuinely amazing. And then she like holds his award and the guy that was the guy that was one of the, I forget what they're called, but the people that are in charge of escorting people on and off the stage,
right,
and kind of telling which way to go, kind of started to pull her off for a second, but then realized that he was like, nope, I she's too sweet. I'm just going to let her be. And she just stands next to him the whole time as he's thanking people for this award. And she's genuinely just like beaming at him. I'm like, that's,
get to all those wonderful moments at the Academy Award.
That's all good. Yeah, that I thought was a great moment. Sorry to interrupt you, Matt.
No, you're not at all. I mean, I'm here to talk about whatever you guys want to talk about. And I'm curious of like how many of the movies you guys watched and different things like that. But like the ceremony itself, like it was just, they did this thing where they cut like 8 awards out of the show to try to speed things up and try to appeal to more of a mass audience. They put in all these different things, like a performance of We Don't Talk About Bruno. And then they put in these fan favorite moments and things like that, which I think in concept, like the Oscars are always trying every year to do something different to try to get more people to watch. And ironically, you just had to have Will Smith smack someone on stage and then people will actually watch. But it's like even those Oscars fan favorite moments, you have that countdown. And the number one thing is the Flash enters the Speed Force from Justice League or Zack Snyder's Justice League.
See, that's the thing. That's the biggest travesty that nobody's talking about right now, Andy Cortez, is that the fucking Avengers Assemble was number 3. Are you kidding me?
I agree. The most disgusting event of the night.
The most egregious occurred
when the hardcore Zack Snyder fans showed the fuck everything. Up.
What the fuck? They were like,
they want any sort of recognition possible.
Oh my god, dude. I laughed so hard when that happened because I was like, it was number 3, and I was like, okay, number 2 and number 1 better be fucking bangers. And of course, number 2 was the Spider-Man swinging together from No Way Home. And I'm like, okay, that's cool. What the hell could number 1 be? And it's The Flash running into the Speed Force from the Snyder cut of Justice League. And I'm like, wow, this show has gone off the fucking rails. And I gotta tell you, I'm in for it.
I was kind of there too. And then they trolled us again by having Zack Snyder's Army of the Dead be the number 1 fan favorite movie. And I was like, how did we let this happen?
Because like, the people who are supporters of Snyder, say what you will about them, they're organized. These guys know what they're doing. They understand how to use Reddit. They understand how to buy AMC stock. They know what the fuck's going on out there, man.
That was their insurrection. Let's be honest. God,
that was, that was their January 6th. It was incredible. Holy shit.
I just loved when they showed those clips on the big screen and they would cut to the audience and everyone's just silent afterwards. Like no one even knows how to react. You just have all these people. None of these movies are nominated for anything. And then ironically,
some of them
when
aren't
they
even
cut
from this year.
No, it's just it's so it's
came
like
out
Zack
like 5
Snyder's,
years ago.
Zack Snyder's Justice League, a movie that did not come to theaters. And I know more street, like, I mean, Coda was a streaming movie and things like that. But it was just like, it's just so bizarre and weird what they tried to do to the show. And it still went to like 11:45 p.m. my time last night. And it's like, and then they cut all these awards out and then showed them in like clip packages and things like that. And Dune won all of those technical awards. And Dune is probably the most popular movie that out of all of them. And they're trying to do this to appeal to more people. And then the movie that probably made the most money out of all of the nominees, all of its awards were given out like in the pre-show and then shown in clip packages. So it was just kind of weird. And I hate to be so negative because like I do think that there are some good movies there that got like nominated and won awards. Like I really do like Coda a lot. Like I think it's one of those movies that I'm probably not going to necessarily like remember 5 years down the line. And it's just one of those feel good kind of like warm hug movies that like crowd pleasers that, you know, every once in a while win Best Picture. And I think some people are kind of mad at that and I don't get it. Like, I guess because things like Dune or Power of the Dog or West Side Story are like these quote unquote better movies, but I don't know. Like I think Coda was wonderful and probably was my favorite movie of the bunch. So
I think it's shocking to me that Will Smith finally won Best Actor. And you're meaning to tell me that Will Smith did not win in 2007 for Pursuit of Happiness, arguably the greatest role of all time. Lost to Forrest Whitaker, and also guess who was nominated for Best Supporting Actor? One of the best movies of all time, Mark Wahlberg as Staff Sergeant Dignam in The Departed.
Hell yeah!
Listen, Andy, listen.
That sounds like such a joke.
Every once in a while, and Matt will tell you, right? The Academy gets together and they try to fix some sort of error that happened a long time ago, right? So Will Smith has done great movies. He's had great roles, and he probably should have won a long time ago. And I haven't seen King Richard. Yeah, I haven't seen it yet. I need to watch it. I still will watch it. I love Will Smith still. But this definitely smacks of, listen, we should have given Martin Scorsese the award for Wolf of Wall Street. Well, what's this next movie he turned out? The Departed. God. We can all agree The Departed is a trash heap.
We can't agree.
Old apple cores and Pepsi maple fucking cans that are discarded.
He's just mentioning the last thing. He's doing it. It's just the last thing you remember.
I just like to dunk on The Departed every once in a while.
I mean, to be fair, you're right that he probably should have won for Goodfellas, and that's probably why they gave him that award for Departed. But I mean, Departed is a fantastic movie, and you're wrong.
All right. You know what? We're having your signal's breaking up here, Matt. You going through a tunnel somewhere?
Oh, don't be like that, dude.
I will say some of the other moments that I liked to riff off this for a second, and shout out to Coda. I as cheesy as it was, guys, and as awkward as it was, I got a kick out of the Pulp Fiction reunion. I got a kick out of seeing Uma Thurman, Samuel Jackson, John Travolta. Well, that was weird. And I understand. I'm like, listen, I understand we're trying to figure out reasons to bring people back to the fray that we want to see again. But that was a weird one. The Juno one was a weird one, too. They were like, let's celebrate Juno. I was like, I haven't thought of that movie in a long time. But good to see the cast of that movie come back. I mean, whatever. I like all these actors. But I don't know that we necessarily needed an excuse to bring them back on stage. But seeing Uma Thurman and John Travolta dancing behind Samuel L. Jackson and having him talk shit to them while they did it, that was a particular highlight for me of the show.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, I think a lot of those reunions were kind of random, but I mean, some people were calling out, like, why do you have Pulp Fiction at 28 years? But like, I think E.T. is either on its 40th this year and you didn't have anything for E.T. And like, I mean, it's probably based on who they could actually get or who would want to come together and do stuff. Like the Godfather reunion with like those guys just looked so old. Like,
they're so old.
De Niro and Pacino and Francis Ford Coppola. Like, it just came out on 4K, I think, and it's having a big kind of resurgence for a big anniversary. But those reunions did feel kind of strange, and then it just kind of added to the whole show feeling very weird.
I'll say this, though. Whoever cut the package for The Godfather, I forget what song was in there, but they threw a hip-hop song in there, and it fucking slapped. And I was like, that is a dope package for The Godfather. And then those three geriatric men wheeled themselves out on stage. And I was like, oh, no. Actually, no. Coppola looked good. I thought De Niro looked good, too. But Pacino's I'm like, I don't know what's going on with Pacino here.
No, Bob Saget in the In Memoriam.
That was a tough one. But I will say,
this year? Not last year, right?
Well, I mean, they still included, I think, people who died this year.
Like, it's not like they couldn't. Yeah, I don't think that.
I don't think you make the cut.
I thought
that's what it was. They gotta make these. They gotta.
If Leonardo DiCaprio passed away like 2 weeks ago, they're not January gonna not put 2nd. Him in the anymore. That's when he's eligible for next.
That's why they always say, Kevin. They say if you're gonna die, you gotta die at the end of December, early January.
That's right. Yeah.
Just what a weird.
God, that was terrible. The In Memoriam was a weird one.
It was way too upbeat, right?
It was like, way too fucking upbeat. And at the end of it, I was celebrating like, I think them we're and supposed stuff, to. But... Yeah, but by the end of it, I came away. I was like, I don't know. I think we're supposed to be like happy that some of these people died. I will say the Bill Murray moment got me. And then I'm always a sucker for anyone who wants to talk positively about Betty White. Just
totally.
Betty White was a fucking badass. She was GOAT level. So, but Bill Murray talking about Ivan Reitman, I showed it. I got a little teary eyed for that. It's actually crazy they got Bill Murray too, which is insane. But absolutely. That was kind of
other weird thing for the Bond montage, having like Tony Hawk and Sean White come out and intro the Bond montage. I'm like, I don't get that at all. That like being a very British franchise, and they're like, you know who's extreme? James Bond.
Yeah.
So they bring out those guys, and I'm like, what a weird choice.
It was very strange. And made stranger so by the fact that while they were doing it, my wife was buzzing around. I was watching it. She'd already seen it. And I was like, oh, man, you know, it'd be so fucking cool. And she was like, what? I was like, if just they brought Adele out right now to sing the Skyfall theme. And my wife was like, Billie Eilish is there. She's going to sing the theme to No Time to Die. I was like, I don't want that. I want
She was good, though. She was good.
It was a good performance, but it's no Adele Skyfall, bro. Come on.
I agree.
I love that Nick just wants his favorite songs from like 10 years ago.
This is why, honestly, if they let me program the Academy Awards, it would be bonkers. But I'd be like, now, ladies and gentlemen, Adele. And she would just sing the Skyfall theme. People like, there's no reference.
One more time.
One more time. Just every 30 minutes, Adele comes back out and sings the Skyfall theme.
Nick, I need to stop.
I'm like, Adele, you're a badass. You can do this. You can make the rules. That was weird. The Billie Eilish performance was good, though. I don't love that song as much as I love some of the other themes.
That's fair.
Kudos to her for winning. That was cool.
Everybody, the Guile theme from Street Fighter 2.
Hey, guys, we're going to have a 35-minute discussion about which Batman cowl was the best. Start with you. Is this just a podcast now? As everyone knows, when you're throwing a live show, it's real cheap to do a podcast for 2 hours and eat it.
I wouldn't have put it past them. Like, even Megan Thee Stallion coming out and doing a verse on We Don't Talk About Bruno was just at a left field as well, being like, here's the world's most popular song right now, and we're going to replace 75% of it with something else.
Man, I'll tell you what. Funny. That was a fever pitch, man. That thing was just a crazy looking dream. And this is me. I have not seen Encanto yet. I don't know how that slipped through the cracks. I think it's just because if Tim Geddes doesn't tell me to watch a movie, I don't see it.
Right.
But all of those songs sound really, really fun. And they look like they're having a good time with it. I have zero context for that. So imagine watching that and never having seen the movie. I was like, I should watch
the world's wildest Disney cruise. Yeah. I love Encanto as well. I mean, I'm kind of sad for Mitchell's versus the Machines, which was one of my favorite movies.
I love that one, Matt.
I love that movie so much, and I feel like what Sony's doing with their animation from Spider-Verse kind of onward is kind of getting to those Pixar levels. And then Disney with 3 nominees, and they win that category every year, and I think Encanto is a wonderful movie. Like, I really, really think it's great, but I think Mitchell's versus the Machines is pretty special, so I was kind of bummed at that. But again,
I like seeing the tweet from Phil Lord talking about, like, man, you're just it. If you keep on advertising animation to only be for kids, people are going to think it's only for kids. Like, the way that it was presented was in such like a, hey, here's a, we all those kids love them cartoons, so here's the award for the best cartoon. Like,
it's insufferable to parents and kind of things like that.
Unfortunately. Brutal.
Well, if Phil Lord has a problem with it, he needs to hurry the hell up and release Into the Spider-Verse 2. Let's go. Yeah. Let's go, because that for sure is going to win. Didn't the first one must have won, right?
It did win it, because they didn't get nominated for the Lego Movie, which was wild. And
another
then
travesty. That movie was great,
which is fantastic, and they didn't even get a nomination. Lego and Batman then they won. They won for Spider-Verse, and then this year should be interesting because you have Turning Red, then you have Spider-Verse, and then the Super Mario Brothers movie's coming in December.
You think that's gonna be up there?
A lot of people are saying that's the Departed of animated movies. It's gonna be trash heap full of rats and fucking rat kings and all sorts of bad twists and turns they stole from a foreign movie.
I think a Mario movie will be there only because there will only be like 4 or 5 marquee animation movies.
Well, Lightyear's coming out too.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, Lightyear.
That's probably there. Lightyear's gonna be on there.
Year's gonna be lit year.
If they even have the Academy Awards next
like
year,
light
we'll
year.
See.
Yeah, got it. Yeah, we'll see. They'll do it, but I mean, I don't know. It's wild. Other things like Jane Campion winning for Power of the Dog is cool. You have back-to-back women winning Best Director, which I think is really cool. Chloe Zhao winning last year.
I love that she gave a little dig to Kevin Costner. She's like,
thanks,
Kevin.
That speech was weird, right? Or his
really
syndrome.
Dramatic, which was strange because Kevin Costner got up there and I was like, I don't know what the fuck.
About
I watched like 30
theater.
Seconds of it. Like, what's he talking about? He got lost in there somewhere? It's overly dramatic? I don't know. I'm sure he was talking about something important, but I'm like,
sometimes you get the attention on you and you panic, you know, and you say saying weird shit.
I mean, I've never experienced that, Kevin.
Yeah.
That was cool, though. Yeah, that was cool. Oh, man. What else?
Did you guys watch many of the nominees or no? Because, Kevin, I know you last couple years have tried to watch every nominee. I don't know if you kind of slipped this year, if you watched them.
So this is the first year where I haven't done that. And I only watched like 3 of the Best Picture nominees.
I saw which ones. I haven't seen Coda yet. That's on my queue. Only because I forget about Apple TV Plus. Like, I forget about that.
Most people do.
Yeah. So usually when I come to them, I'm like, shit, there's a lot of great, I know, there's a lot of great movies on there. Again,
blowing my fucking brain.
Severance supposed to be really, really good.
Yeah, I think it's kind of underrated, their streaming service.
The fucking Mahershala Ali movie that came out earlier this year was incredible.
Oh, is it good? I haven't watched it yet.
Yes, it's really fucking good. You should watch that. You'll love it. But I saw Drive My Car.
Yeah.
All 18 hours of it.
I watched it in five different parts yesterday before the Oscars. Yeah.
Was not, it's a movie that I really wanted to like. And I can't get through this. And I saw it in theaters. And when you see something like that long in theaters, I'm like, I gotta go. And of course, Dune I saw. And I didn't expect Dune to win, though. I don't even think Dune necessarily should have won. I just think from a technical standpoint, it was a very beautifully made movie. And I'm a big fan of the team that made it. But I'm not mad that Dune didn't win. I would have rather Blade Runner 2049 won than Dune.
Totally. Yeah, I mean, it winning all those technical awards makes sense to me. Really do think that it's kind of half of a movie, so I don't like. And I think I'm curious once I see that second half if I think it comes together totally. But like, it's just a weird thing for something that I don't think has a complete beginning to end in that first part one to be like.
Yeah, it's not the second part. You could see maybe winning for the culmination of both films.
I think it will.
It'll get
a bunch of haters. We gotta have Mike watch all the movies on a phone.
Michael,
I watched Jackass Oscars in review
three times. Okay,
watched Jackass three times.
It's better every time. It's deeper every time you watch it.
Yeah, on a smaller screen each subsequent time.
Mike's watching it on his Apple Watch. Yeah, there you go. Jesus Christ,
that's funny. Yeah, I mean the nominees were I like again. I hate being a negative guy, but like it's this year to me felt kind of underwhelming. Like I think all of the movies were. Like if I'm going off the kind of funny scale, like 3s out of 5s, like nothing was bad, but like nothing really like Coda, I thought was lovely. I saw it at Sundance like a year and a half ago. And like, I haven't had a real desire to watch it again, but loved it when I saw it. And it was the thing that I was kind of sort of cheering for, but I wouldn't have kind of cared if it didn't. And like thought Belfast was okay. I liked Don't Look Up. I know that movie's very polarizing, but like, I kind of liked the sledgehammer to the head approach to that. Like again, but something that I haven't really thought about. Drive My Car. I'm kind of with you, Nick, where I liked it, but I'm like, I don't know, this is a little too long, and I think I can appreciate this more than I really enjoyed it. Dune,
that's a perfect way of putting it.
Yeah,
I respect Dune, that movie. I never need to watch it again.
Exactly. Yeah. I said what I thought about Dune. King Richard, again, Will Smith is good, but I thought it was like a decent sports movie. Licorice Pizza, great filmmaking, but I have some issues with kind of the relationship portrayed and some of the kind of insensitive jokes in that movie and stuff. And I love Paul Thomas Anderson, but like, and I think that's a really fun movie, but there's some stuff in there that I don't love.
Paul Thomas Anderson is one of those directors I really want to like, but the only movie of his that I can even stand by is Boogie Nights. Everything else I've watched of his, I'm just like, I don't like him as a filmmaker. I don't vibe with him. There Will Be Blood, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't dig that. Inherent Vice, I couldn't get through 5 minutes of him. I'm like, what the fuck is going on with this movie? It's weird. Just weird.
Punch Drunk Love.
Punch Drunk Love. Punch Drunk Love, I should have seen when it came out because I tried watching that a few weeks ago and I'm like, nope. I don't want to watch this movie. I like that. I don't like it. It's weird as fuck.
It's weird as shit, but I like it.
It's like watching a Safdie.
Adam Sandler can be a great.
Yeah, 100%.
Adam Sandler can be a great actor when he actually tries, which is fantastic.
Very sure. But I prefer my Adam Sandler, Andy, of course, like you prefer him in Grown Ups, right? We need Where's Grown Ups 3? Let's get that movie back.
We're definitely not getting Will Smith in any future iteration of Grown Ups. That's for damn sure.
No. But you better. I mean, here's the deal. Not to call back too much of this. These guys need to squash this. Apologies need to be made across the board. And they need to come out and intro the next Academy Awards. It needs to be Chris Rock and Will Smith doing the gate.
They did that,
throwing a fake punch at each other and then hugging and being like, whatever. You know, like this is not something that needs to be a career ending thing for any of these guys. Like, let them handle this shit like adults and then bring them back and let's make a joke about it. It'll make light of it next year.
Get Chris Rock in the next Bad Boys.
Yes, exactly, right? Make another fucking Bad Boys. Let's start there. How about that?
They're good.
Now we can talk best pictures. Jesus Christ. All these mediocre movies. Jesus.
Exactly.
I think someone was saying P. Diddy already came out and said that they already kind of squashed it like after the Oscars.
I'm sure they did. I mean, look, dude. It's Chris Rock is a big he's a fucking massive star. I'm sure I don't think he tweeted anything about this either. I don't think he's even said anything about this.
No.
So I think he's just like, whatever.
Like, we all just give it up for our friend Will Smith, who was getting nonstop tweets all night.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Oh, that sucks.
Poor man.
Yeah, like, that sucks. You talk about the Mike? Tweet engagement of that. I mean, last I checked, it had about 300-something thousand likes on it. And everybody, like, even when he tweeted Welp, because he knew the shitstorm was coming.
Yep.
It right now has 678,000 likes.
Oh, my God.
It has 13K quote retweets, 56,000 retweets. A lot of people just thought it was actually Will Smith tweeting at the time of it.
Yeah.
Real quick. That's Mike, wild. Mike, I'm going to have to run outside. Do you want me to cut over to the other
feed?
Yeah,
will you switch over, switch over to my feed.
Anyway, all the mentions were hilarious. It's funny watching our friends interact with it, but it's even funnier. Like, I had so much fun reading comments from people that were legitimately just having back and forths, not knowing that this wasn't the Will Smith that they saw on TV slap Chris Rock. It's so funny watching the obliviousness in all these people. So.
I will say one of my tweets that I could not stop laughing at last night was Blessing's tweet about that, which he had a banger, man, right out of the gate, got it out there right where I slacked it to you. I don't know if
did
you
that one take off. Did that one take off?
I don't know. I retweeted it because I wanted it to take off
about Bel Air.
Yeah, they were like, he's gonna have to move. Blessing says something like, he's gonna have to move in with his auntie and uncle in Bel Air after this one. And I'm like, that's a great take. That's a funny ass.
Pretty good too. It's at 4,700 likes.
That's great.
Not bad. Not
Alana bad. Had one as well that I think is at about a billion likes right now.
Well, yeah, Alana and I had a joke one time about how she could just fucking tweet the word pizza and it would fucking pop off, and she did it, and it did pop off. Yeah, it got like 18,000 likes. I was like, see, Alana, you just tweet whatever the fuck. Just tweet the word pizza right now. Yeah, yeah, it's, her tweet is at 127,000 likes.
Yeah, that sounds about right. That sounds about right.
Yeah.
Man, somebody responded, I think, to her tweet though, and had the funniest fucking thing. He said, "Left Chris's face with some fresh prints."
Oh, that's good. Oh, good. That's really good.
Really fucking good. Shout out to Sean Pokey Plato for that. And I don't know who this person is. So if he said horrible shit on any other tweets, I don't want that shit coming back on me. But that one thing he said was funny. I guess I could have looked him up.
Well, let's have some fun. I want to give a big thank you to Matt Rohrbach for coming to join us and talking about all the incredible nominations and the movies that we should know about there and all the winners. Matt, we're going to do some fun clips. So you're more than welcome to hang out with us if you got time.
Sure.
But I got some fun clips for everybody out here. And of course, Nick, this one's dedicated to you because I know one day you're going to be so big, you're going to need your own security. And this is Cardi B at Disneyland or Disney World, some awesome amusement park. So take a look at Cardi B and her security.
A lot of people call me the Cardi B of Kind of Funny.
I always say.
Amazing. Amazing. Look at it. I love the juxtaposition of the two teacups. You got Cardi B and her daughter hanging out having a great time. This dude looks miserable in this other car. He's like, I don't like this at all. Also, the teacups make me kind of woozy, I'll be honest with you guys.
Oh, yep. Don't go on the teacups with my mom. Well, she loves those.
Does she spin the car real
hard? Oh, like, so fast. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. For me.
Really?
Once watched my dad violently vomit because she did that to all of us.
That's where I'm at right there.
She loves that.
Yeah, that's so fun.
And then here's a great follow-up tweet. I don't know if you've seen this guy on amusement park rides, but he's hysterical. The follow-up tweet was Cardi B security looking like this.
How do you not crack a smile?
Incredible. This guy needs to be a superstar. He's fucking hilarious.
Oh my god, bro.
That's funny.
Moving on. This has taken over the internet, Nick. I don't know if you or Andy or Matt saw this one, but this TikTok right here has literally taken over the internet. Now, people are saying no sound. I have muted the second half of most of them. Are you telling me you don't get any sound at all?
I'm not hearing any sound coming through.
Oh, really? Now, no sound.
No sound.
No.
So if you want to check in on that.
Well, Kevin's gone. Kevin's moving dirt, so we're not checking in on anything.
Silent movie time. Silent movie.
Kevin is outside moving dirt as we speak, so guess what?
I'm right here. I've got my head.
You get no genuine
jackals. All right.
Kevin, can we check this out, please?
I mean, I'm sure that it's a mic.
Kevin's 12 feet underground excavating the site.
Sorry, I have to handle this right now.
Check your settings, Mike, because it's probably you.
Hold on, no, he's good, actually. Give me 1 second.
Is he good? Okay. God, poor, look at Will Smith down there crying. What a crazy night, guys. What a crazy night.
It was wild. Hold on, 1 second. Audio.
Oh, my God, that's great.
Oh, man. Kevin is spelunking.
All right, go ahead. Mike, I'm not getting any levels from you, actually. Play something?
Oh, that's Mike's fault. Jesus Christ.
I see it now.
I hear it.
You hear it?
Of course it was Mike's fault.
It's not my fault.
Great, great. Damn it, Mike.
It was my fault. It was my fault.
Okay, we good? We good?
Yeah, man, I just wanted to blame Mike.
Yeah.
I know. You guys love that.
I'm just happy no one's blaming me.
Kevin, go back to the dirt. Back to the dirt. We'll handle this. So this took over TikTok last week, and this is a great one. So just two homies having fun.
Just two guys enjoying the swans. What's better than this, man? What's better than this, man? Can't beat it. Can't beat it.
I'm hearing double.
I hear my guy.
Wait.
Fucking Mike.
Just two guys enjoying the swans. What's better than this, man?
Nothing, man. Can't beat it.
Can't beat it.
We gotta figure out how to talk to women.
I was just thinking.
It's funny. We watched that clip 17 times. It got funny.
Oh, my funny God. No, that is the best.
That's funny.
Up next, this young man gets lost.
Oh, this is incredible.
This one is incredible. I've seen this.
Is he watching Zorba? Not
Zola.
Zorba.
Zola. Yeah.
That is not an appropriate movie to watch on a plane. why would they put that on the plane?
Just look at his eyes.
This kid just hit puberty right there. He's like, oh! This kid just discovered something. Amazing. He's going to be chasing after his entire life.
Amazing. Oh,
good for you, buddy.
That's so funny.
Also, Zola's a fucking great movie. Everyone should watch that.
It is.
So is that the Adam Sandler one?
No, it's Riley Keough and Taylor Page, I want to see was her name.
I'm thinking You Don't Mess With the Zohan.
No, Zohan, very distinctly different movie. Zola's the one based on the Twitter, on the woman live tweeting this crazy shit that happened to her like her down in Florida. It's great, watch it. It's weird.
Cousin Greg is in it.
If that sells you, he's really tall.
This is way too fast for this dog to be going.
This dog cruising, Andy. Andy knows how to push too.
Dude, this dog wants it though, Andy. Like you look at this dog.
360. Oh shit!
First off, Andy, you look at this dog and you're trying to put limits on this dog that you apply to yourself, and that's just wrong.
You're right.
You can't put this dog in a box. I look at it and I say, this dog's going to fucking roll a hip and break its leg and have to be put out of its misery. And then he starts going faster. He wants to go faster. And I think, who am I to tell this little dog what to do? Look, he's fucking shrouping this thing, dude.
I wish the other dog ran up to it and asked for a selfie. Like this dog is a celebrity to the other dog. Like, he's a TikTok star in the dog world. You know what I mean?
Let me tell you. I mean, that's the question. The big question, Andy, is how do you catch a fucking rainbow? How do you catch something that's moving that fast? You can't do it.
Tony Dog.
Andy, I would have went with like Tony Bark or something.
Yeah, you've
like
tried that, before, Andy. That was not one of the times you tried hard.
That was a hawk and a dog, both animals.
Yeah,
so.
Tony Dog.
Tony Dog. Bony Hawk.
Oh my god. Bony
Kelly Slater Dog.
Up next, right now, we're going to need a cleanup on this one.
Guys, so Mary doesn't believe that I could chug a Red Bull in 2 seconds.
Why are this guy's eyes so incredible?
Oh, fake.
He did that purpose, yeah.
I hate when people try to do
that. That's the best, bro.
I hate fake videos. Mike would like fake videos.
That's the new move. I'm doing that to somebody's car. Kevin, get ready.
You're banned. These people are banned. If you do a stupid fake thing like this and try to pass it off like it's real, you get banned from TikTok.
Oh, I was just going to spray a Red Bull over in your face.
I would be pissed off if you raced the sugar-free Red Bull, man.
Yeah, that's so gross. That's the most offensive thing about it.
Oh, my God. We're going to need to clean up part two over on this episode.
Oh, what's wrong with him? Oh, no.
What the fuck? Did somebody throw up? Oh, the drink fell.
Oh, shit.
Oh,
he dropped the drink on the baby.
Oh.
That kid's hammered now.
Oh, fuck. Look at the baby's face.
It was cold. It's probably cold, poor kid. That kid's not going to know why she hates snow.
Oh, fuck. Oh, Jesus. That's got to be, that kind of wakes you up and is a startle that you didn't need, you know?
Like, yeah, oh, you're just wet for the rest of the dinner. You
yeah,
know
like, you're
just,
sticky.
It's going to be wet.
Sugary.
Sorry, I just got back. Is the audio, did we figure
you
that out?
You found the Triceratops? Yeah, you found good. The Triceratops now?
Yeah, you good? You good?
what is yeah,
this?
I'll
look at this other homie fucking
still wait, did we sort out the audio?
Yeah we did.
Yeah,
why you out of breath?
What?
Why you out of breath?
He just moved like 10 sandbags.
Because Kevin started a fight club in his basement. That's why he's
out of breath. All right, guys. Come on.
Why do you think he's out of breath, Andy? He's been moving dirt all fucking day. Andy's on a bag. You're on a bag today. What the fuck is this? Why do you get children shit like this? This is not a toy you should buy any kid. Kids don't deserve
I don't think
shit
that's
like
definitely not a child's toy. She's holding a remote control for the RC.
Yeah,
car, right?
Don't put this in. Look at this. I guarantee you read that box. It says yep. Children over
oh!
the
air.
What could that person have thought was going to happen in that moment?
Oh, no.
Oh my God!
You gotta think, Kevin. On some small level, this dad just needed this to happen. This kid's just been killing his soul, and he needed this kid just to hurt for a second.
Like you need the kid to get humbled. Like, all
yeah,
right, listen,
fucking,
kid.
This is what you get for crying all night long, kid.
The world can fucking like rock you. All right, at any moment. Yeah. So chill out. Oh, quit being a little cocky asshole. You know.
Jesus, this kid. The ego on this kid.
Kevin, this is you and I, Kevin. This is called the baguette vending machine.
Oh,
shut the fuck up. Oh.
Hell yeah.
What is this little puppy? All right,
how do we do this?
Oh, look, okay, do you have a Euro 20?
I do. You do? I do have a Euro 20. The only concerning
is if this is fresh, I'm going to lose my mind.
Yeah.
I'm sure it is, right? I'm sure some bakery just
you got to No, I mean like morning. You know cuz like they have a lot they make pizzas. I wonder if this bakes it as well.
Oh, sure. No, I don't think it bakes it. I think it probably just spits out a piece of bread.
You
don't
think so? You're right. Oh yeah, it just sort of shoots it down. You don't think they have lamps in there? Like,
oh
the way
my god, I love that it doesn't even. It's not even like.
Oh my god, it's like full length though.
I would still eat the shit out of that.
Oh, I'd eat the shit out of it without question.
Oh
Nicholas.
Man,
this guy. Oh man. Bro, you gotta crack a baguette. What are you, a savage? You gotta snap
man.
A baguette.
You know what I want? Like,
no, in Paris,
I just want.
Like that.
I want some of that. I want some of the. The dipping, the olive oil and the fucking...
Oh, a little tapenade or like a little
the
olive
garlic
oil
sort of crunchy pieces. Oh, my God.
This reminds me, last weekend, not last weekend, the weekend prior to last, the comics threw a yearly, in San Francisco, threw a yearly park outing where everyone gets together and just has like a little picnic. And one of my friends decided to eat mushrooms and sat and made a... Took a fucking like... 3 foot long baguette. I have no idea where she got it from. And just opened it up slowly with her hands and started stuffing ham and cheese into it. And then after, I kid you not, about an hour and a half of making this thing, she was like, do you want some? I was like, I'm like, you didn't even put anything. It was just on the grass. You better stop doing mushrooms, kids.
Up next. So can we... This is all sorts of sports segment. Run the graphic, Kevin.
Yes, this is how. This is yes. I love this energy.
No, the graphic's not set up for this.
Okay,
page.
I'll give
I'm
you the
sorry,
graphic. Yo, welcome into another episode of All Sorts of Sports with Andy Cortez and your co-host Snowbike Mike. Andy, this week I'm taking you to the diamond. But the diamond is gonna get a little sexy. I don't know if you've seen the Savannah Bananas, but they like to have fun when playing baseball for their crowd. And so they get everybody involved. They're a big TikTok superstar for their baseball team, but they got the ump involved this time. So let's enjoy.
Never been more tired from dusting off.
Oh, he's shaking
oh
it.
Jesus, he's
Jesus
getting
Christ.
It.
Christ. This guy.
Good for him.
Good for you, bro. What's this guy gonna
What a
do?
Good song, too, man.
That was incredible.
Yes. So these guys have a great TikTok account. They're always having fun on the diamond doing some dumb stuff. And
yeah,
I like to see the ump involved.
Nick, they allow people in the crowd to catch a fly ball and it counts as an out. Yes. If someone hits a pop awesome. Foul,
yeah, that's awesome.
And like a guy caught it with a glove, like, and everybody's like, "That's a third out of the game!" Woo!
That's great. That's amazing. Fucking great. That makes me
this
so happy.
This is what the MLB needs.
Yeah, yes. No, that's how we fix baseball.
They need shot clocks. They need everything to be an out. That's it.
I gotta say, I love the other team they're playing is called the Party Boys, and they are sleeveless T-shirts with a fake tuxedo on the front. It is a great look, right?
So Mike, why do you need sleeves when you're ready to party?
Oh my god, when you're just greased up too. This I love that they're greased up.
I know. Why are his arms so sweaty?
I love the idea of the Savannah Bananas doing something to make the league really unique, and then the other team's going, "How do we one up this?" So then the Party Boys do their thing, and then another team somehow tries to one up that with some sort of gimmick. Like, let's make baseball fun again, man. This is
baseball fun again. Andy is right.
This is great. This is great.
And so, Andy, of course, you and I both know the big Aristotle, big Cactus. Okay. The big Diesel. He's known for one thing, Nick, Kevin, and Matt, tearing down the rim. Well, this youngster right here has taken it to the next level. So let's watch this.
Let's watch this. Oh no!
Jesus Christ!
I've seen this one. I've seen
that. That's very dangerous.
That's not good.
He ripped down the whole thing, bro. That's insane.
I always wondered if those things
be able to take the weight of one human being, especially a high schooler. You know,
I think. How do those things affix to the top,
to the ceiling,
right?
To the rafters.
So that thing just came undone. That is not good. Yeah. That thing was not put up. That was like definitely like last day. The guys were like, "We got to get the fuck out of here. We got shit to do." Just
how much are they checking that at the local gymnasium? You know what I mean? Your local high school. Who's really getting up there and checking it on the regular?
I bet now they're gonna check it once a month.
Checking that all the time. We gotta keep a logbook.
Do you think they finish the game?
No, the game's over. You end that. Everybody's got to go home. You're not getting that back up.
You got to check the other one. You got to check the one that's hanging over the stands. You got to check all these. Because, look, there's one hanging over the stands. Could kill those people if it falls down.
Pretty wild. So I thought this was a pretty great one for your all sorts of sports. Now we're moving into the community submitted. Of course, thank you to the nanobiologist for submitting a fun clip. Just like you can if you drop 500 biddies or a $5 donation with your link. It will go through me, the Great Wall of Mike. And then I will present it to the boys to have some fun with here on our Kind of Funny morning show. So let's see what nanobiologist has brought to us today.
You might not like it, but this is what the peak male athletic form looks like, and there ain't a fucking thing you can do about it.
That was great.
This man is so much. Look at him.
Kevin, it's the stop. This needs to be me and you at the new studio, rollerblading around shirtless all the time.
We were so close to buying rollerblades, Kevin. We almost got everybody rollerblades. We should have
I'll
done
fucking
that.
Take a pair of rollerblades.
We were on such a massive rollerblade kick for a moment there.
This guy, Andy, there was like a moment where people rollerbladed and then everyone agreed to stop, and this guy never stopped. He just kept going.
Stop.
And he laughs. Andy, he laughs.
That's why he's so good now.
Stuff. Exactly. So good. Once you blade, you never stop.
Yeah.
I do appreciate his name. Air Manatee is a great name. Air Manatee is his name.
That's so great. Good
just
for
so
him.
Everybody knows he's got good an incredible name you can go check out there.
That guy's great.
He gets it, bro. He's just sending it all the time, man.
It's one of those things where, like, do you – I'd like to imagine that wherever this dude works at, that his coworkers don't know what a celebrity and what an athlete he really is.
They don't get it.
By night, you know?
He doesn't want him to know because he wants to stay humble, right? He doesn't want the situation to change. But once they find out, it's going to change forever. There's no putting that genie back in the bottle.
It's like Ron Swanson when he's his jazz persona, his saxophone persona.
Midnight something, right?
Something silver, right?
I thought. Silver, yeah.
Yeah. Right, I'd like to imagine that, like, he's working at this auto shop and then his boss is like, younger relatives come in who are all on TikTok and they're like, "Oh my god, Air Manatee works here."
Oh my god.
The boss is like, "Who the fuck is Air Manatee?"
First off, this guy
works
at a microbrewery in Portland.
Yeah,
he serves really hoppy IPAs.
But he lives the blade.
But he fucking loves the blade. He just he does two things. Blade, he drinks IPAs and he fucking blades, man.
Oh, this guy somehow rollerblades so slowly.
Yeah, I was gonna say, nothing is as impressive as that first shot.
Yeah, this stuff looks like something Kevin could do with a couple days of practice.
Yeah.
I want, also, days. It's not go. A good look. Oh, this is incredible.
Dude, Air Manly's getting it, bro. Oh,
holy shit.
Hell yeah.
Okay. We all can just eat our
knees
fucking
almost
words.
Buckled there.
We all can just eat our stupid words because this guy is a hero.
I almost right have the knee right hyperextension. Yeah. Right there.
Yeah, that's not good. Already. That's not good. You're putting a lot of weight on those knees the wrong way.
A little
oh
scared.
My God.
I don't want to watch this again.
It's incredible. All right, Kevin, take back over the feed. That was your fun clips for the week. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for Kevin moving all his dirt that he needed to do and allowing me to run that for you. You know, hope you enjoyed that. But great stuff, everybody. That was your kind of funny morning show for the day right there. Matt, thank you so much for joining us and hanging out, talking movies, talking the Oscars with us. It's always great to have you, my friend.
No, thank you for having me, guys.
You know it, brother.
Where can people find you, Matt?
Yeah, tell them.
You guys can find me on the Untitled Movie Podcast and the Untitled Movie Reviews. We got some great stuff coming this week. We'll obviously have an Oscars recap that should be out later today or tonight. We'll have a review of the first four episodes of Moon Knight tomorrow.
Ooh.
That you guys can check out at, I think it's 9 a.m. Pacific or maybe 9 a.m. Eastern tomorrow, the embargo breaks. So you'll get the first four episodes, no spoilers, anything like that. So spoiler free. Social embargo is already out, so you can go follow me at Matt Rohrbeck on Twitter. So I have some thoughts on Moon Knight there. And then we're also having a review of Everything Everywhere All at Once later this week, which is phenomenal. I absolutely love that movie. So I can't wait to talk about that. And and I'm also working on Family Feud Canada. So if anyone is in Canada, you can check out some of my questions on that. Thanks for having me, guys.
And second off, in breaking news, I will be returning as a guest on Matt's podcast as soon as I remember to email him back. He's emailed me three times over the last 6 months, and I never email him back. So, Matt, I apologize on that one. I'd love to come back on the show.
It's all good.
I'm so sorry. Of course.
Everyone is always welcome. It's all good.
Beautiful.
Appreciate it, guys. Thank you. Have a good rest of the day and week.
Take care,
Matt. Have a good one. Cheers, guys. I'm looking at myself in the camera today, Nick. You know what I mean? And I was telling Washy. Okay, I was telling my buddy Washy that, like, you know, the sun's coming out. And you know me, I can't really mess around in the sun. Okay?
No, the sun is your mortal enemy.
And he told me, he said, well, the more you stand in the sun, then you'll get tan, Mike. And I said, no, Washy, I just go from lobster pink back to white and then back and forth. I ping pong it back and forth. But I'm telling you, I'm looking at the camera right now.
You look kind of tan.
I'm looking a little sun-kissed is what
you
I call
you are looking
that.
A little tan. It's funny sun-kissed. That Washburn of all people doesn't understand that because I would have pegged him for being the exact same complexion and weakness exactly. to the sun that you have, which is weird to me. But I guess when you don't go outside ever, that you probably don't understand how the sun works.
Mike,
that's
I
a
think
dig you, on Wash if he's.
I think you may just need to color correct your monitor because you are looking beat red on my screen.
You look okay. So you look like you look like a cherry red leather seat in
So on one monitor, I see a different color. On this monitor, though, I'm looking good, and that's all. That
you look good on my monitor.
Me, okay.
In the box in the middle of my monitor, you look like someone punched you in the face, and no pun intended. On this monitor, you look like you just came from the tanning salon. It's great. This is a good morning show, everyone. We had a great.
We had
time
a ton of fun today. Is right. Thank you to all the best friends for joining us and having some fun. Now, Kevin, as I look at the bar, we're nearing the halfway point. Not quite there yet.
last glass gaming says he's sun punched.
Oh my god!
That's so good.
And so I guess before we get into that, let's talk about getting in the sun, okay? So, you know, we got Achievement Hunter Live this week. I'm very excited to meet new people. Should I be getting more sun or should I stop
now,
with the sun? You know what I mean? That's what I need to know.
Wait,
that's a real
Mike,
great question.
Are you using sunscreen?
No. I hate sunscreen's my mortal enemy. Everybody knows that.
I don't like putting sunscreen
what
on.
What does that
here,
mean?
Mike. It's too goopy.
Because it's sticky and gooey and like you just don't feel good you don't need it. Wearing it.
You're not in the sun for 10 minutes and get severe sunburn.
I know. I was at that picnic all day like 2 weeks ago and I was just out there for like 4 hours and I just had a little bit of Just a little bit of sunburn on my forehead. It was pretty nice. Mike and Tim would have died. Now, the thing is this, Mike. We have a history of interacting with the Rooster Teeth and Achievement Hunter folks,
yeah.
and having one of us get burned almost to death because of it from the sun. So
that. Yeah.
Just be aware that at one point Tim Geddes was so sunburned after a trip to see the fine folks over at the Teeth that his whole scalp peeled off. But he, really like a gross. Snake. The scales underneath are real soft. You know what I mean? Like that skin underneath that was so baby soft, man. So, mm-hmm. you know, maybe it's a you know, blessing in disguise.
Okay. Andy,
he was in a lot of
Andy, pain. How do you feel about this? Because, like, you know, I'm trying to make a good first impression, right? You only get one first impression. You're going to be shaking hands, meeting new people. Like, am I going to be embarrassed that I've been sun punched, or should I go back into goblin mode and hide from the sun?
I think you need to recover.
Okay.
I think, like, I don't know if you want your to be known as, like, the guy who was just super sunburned. Like, I don't know, you know.
Like, it is going to be the first time meeting a lot of these people IRL. Yeah. And I think that, I mean, I'm actually now starting to believe the opposite of Andy. I think you do you. If you get sunburned, okay. you roll in just a tank top own and it. Some shorts and own it.
Own it. Yeah. I was thinking, like, you get a good base, right? Like, yesterday, today. I get a good base, and then I go into recluse mode where I hide from the sun for the next 4 days. Hopefully I carry that base, but I'm not extra pink, but like I'm recovering pink. You know what I mean?
I think what if you want to make even more of an impression, wear goggles and continue to do what you've been doing. Like,
okay.
I'd rather see like the severe.
Oh, you want me to get the lines here. Okay.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
You want the goggle tan.
Okay, I think that'll leave a lasting impression.
No way.
I could get a nasty goggle tan.
Can I ask, are we dealing with a farmer's tan here? Does it just stop at the neck? Are you sure?
Oh, of course. Okay. Well, you know what? I mean, it definitely stopped at the neck, but I will say, Nick, on my afternoon hikes with the dogs the past 3 days, what I've been doing is I've been getting out there, right? Nobody's around. Just take the full t-shirt off. I stand in the sun for 5 minutes this way.
Next year
then I turn around, stand in the sun for 5 minutes that way. Yeah, and then I go, you know what
that's
I mean?
That's good
then
for I your go. Vitamin D into your back.
Uh-huh.
That'll keep the skin cancer away. That's good.
So, okay. I'm glad to know that you guys think that. Andy, I might take up your idea of getting the nasty goggle tan. We'll see what happens on Friday. Of course, that's so far away, but we still have some fun to do because I believe the team has now filled up half of the bar. So we should have an additional 30 minutes on the stream. Is that correct? Kevin Coelho.
Yep. Right about half.
Okay. So with that, we should have about an extra 40 minutes by my count right now. And so
yeah, 45.
I think we should play some games, right? Andy Cortez and Nick Scarpino, we should play some games, right?
Yeah.
Now, Nick, there's a special game to us
mm-hmm.
that just came out with a special DLC.
Oh, yeah.
So it's time to channel our inner cop docs.
That's
and
right.
return to doling out justice, but this time to the undead. Andy, so you and I are about to channel our inner undead police officers.
Andy, up against the wall. Up against the wall and spread them. Because the cop docs are here. And if you're doing anything, ladies and gentlemen, that's illegal or needs medical attention, we are on the case. Do you understand me?
What do you mean by cop docs? What are cop docs?
Well, a long time ago, Mike and I played Police Stories, and we crushed that, and then we played Surgery Simulator.
Oh, okay.
And then we became docs as well. So we were anointed by largely.
Wasn't there?
Yeah, there was a third one. We forgot what it was. But we were anointed. It might have been like a taco truck simulator. We don't know. We were anointed by the Twitch chat that we are now cop docs.
Yeah, they did it, not you.
If you have any sort of medical condition, Andy, like a foot fungus, or you want us to look at something, more than happy to do it and charge you standard American healthcare rates, which is $10,000 every for
Andy,
everything.
Quick question. Are you going to have your camera on or off for this next part?
I will have my camera on.
On. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm excited to be returning to Police Stories, Andy, because this is a game that I think you and I should also play through. I don't know if you've seen this game or not, but it is absolutely incredible. And Mike,
Andy, can I buy it for you right now? Would you like me to buy it? You can join us.
I think it's only two player though, Mike.
Yeah.
I know, but like we'll get him involved.
No, it's okay. It's okay.
Let him watch. Okay, so maybe Andy can be dispatch, as Jimmy Two Shoots says right there.
He can read
Andy. Andy can be dispatch. Yeah. That means Kevin now has a new assistant in this dispatch office, and you and I out there are ready to rock.
That's exciting for all of us.
Also, maybe I should be off camera dispatch then, Kevin.
Okay, you can be off camera dispatch. Okay.
Sounds good.
I like that.
Andy, we pay you to be on camera.
Oh, you did it right now. You did it right now. Not
Greg. We're joining the show. Okay. He was gone. Okay, that's it. That's all we got from Greg.
He broke everything. Hold on.
I think Greg came in here by accident. Somebody's
audio. Somebody's audio.
Oh my god!
Why did he come and then leave? Why would he do that?
I think he came in here by accident.
Oh, that's too bad.
That is me. That is in fact me, Kevin. It's coming through my audio output.
Oh, I was well aware of who it was.
Let me see. Do it again. Let me see if that fixed it.
Let me talk. Yep. Yeah, it's coming through.
So my audio for this game is just going to come through no matter what. Mike, you might want to send Kevin your picture on this one.
Wait.
Oh, I can do that. I can do that.
Uh-huh. Yeah, just send
Nick, would you like me to take over your computer and
do it? Just have Mike send it to you, and we'll just have Mike's feed. Okay. That'll be fine.
Okay, I've sent it to you, Kevin.
Bam. Switched it up.
Like there that. Mm-hmm. Switched it up.
All right, Mike.
All right.
Mike, here's the thing, though, Mike. Last time, a lot of people were like, dude, you guys are, like, obviously you're undercover cops, and that's cool, but what's harder than being undercover cops is being cover cops, cops that are just right out there, just everyone can see them, right? So I thought, Mike, it would be a good idea if we finally just told people, like, we're not detectives. We are the fucking law, right? We are the fucking law right now, Mike. Get it fucking ready.
Are we doing it? We're going to do it?
We're doing it. We're doing it.
Okay, because like in my mind, Nick, we're like the RIPD. If you've seen that awesome movie before with Ryan Reynolds, where they were shooting up the
awesome
undead
movie
people.
Is
awesome movie. Great, great.
Awesome one. Movie.
Oh my god, you're ready that fast, bro?
I am the law, everyone.
He's back, everybody. He's fucking back. By the way, what a great logo.
Which one?
The handcuffs as the O is the O. Like, it's great.
You're in for an incredible game right now. An incredible game.
So police stores, you all played through this. You all are solving crimes, killing bad guys, whatever the hell. Zombie case, they are introducing a new element. So this has got to be really exciting for you all.
It's very exciting. First off, Andy, thank you for the question. Second off, Mike he reached out on Friday and said, hey, there's brand new DLC for this. The people that have made this game, and I forget the name of the developer, but they're great, said, hey, do you guys want to play this DLC? And we said, we're going to jump at this, the first ever DLC. And they said, nope, we've added missions. And Mike and I are like, huh, we didn't see those missions. So we're actually going to play through the first DLC that has happened, and then we'll get to the zombie case DLC. But I'm excited for you to see this. Have you seen any part of this game yet, Andy?
I know that it was not what I was expecting. I was expecting more of the time that you and Greg were cops. That's the experience that I was expecting. And then when I saw the gameplay, I saw that it was sort of a kind of a top-down. Yeah. It almost looked like Hotline Miami.
Oh, Mike, that was a good call with the Entenmann's. Right now, I wish we both had cups of coffee, hot cups of coffee that were kind of stale, and some Entenmann's donuts. We just smoke darts and just talk about
it. Oh, my God, bro. I mean, talk about our story about doling out justice to the undead goddamn zombies taking over the universe here.
We're about to be cops. Sir, Andy, get up against the wall. Spread him. Cough.
I already
put down the brains.
I need you to cough. Now, Mike, are we gonna play that? Are we gonna play the continuation of the campaign first, or are we just gonna go straight to busting some zombie ass?
I'd like to bust some zombie ass, Nick, but we're gonna find out in just a second here. Okay, let's see what we can do.
All right, give me your online co-op.
Now, Mike, I don't know if you need to eat the donut to get the.
Oh, I gotta eat the donut.
Okay, got you.
These are my favorite things on planet Earth.
You know, gotta have a donut.
You gotta eat these donuts. Got you. I'm gonna be honest with you.
Got you.
It's okay. Okay.
I love this.
40263 is my code.
Okay. Wait, say that again. Hold on.
40263.
Okay. Joining game. Here we go. Oh, dispatch. We're in, Mike. We're in.
Okay. Looks like it's locked behind a certain number. So we got to go earn some points. We got to dole out some justice.
All right.
Oh, shit.
I'm in.
Dispatch.
Man.
Dispatch, come in. Dispatch.
Dispatch here.
Dispatch, we're about to hit the city slums. We're on the story of Charlie McDennis.
Sounds good.
Dispatch just got on the job, Mike. You're going to have to give Dispatch a little bit more.
You got it.
Dispatch, do you want to read this Dispatch parts? That's your part?
Dispatch, you're going to read this shit in just a second. Dispatch, this is you, Dispatch.
Dispatch to Jones and Rhymes. There was an anonymous noise complaint on the intersection of 13th and 10th. The man sounded frightened. It's a troublesome neighborhood in a real slum. Don't let your guard down. It's probably a simple street fight, but some of the worst troublemakers live there. Get on it and assess the situation. Shouldn't take long. There's no period after shouldn't take long?
It might be more. There might be more.
Oh, we don't have access.
We don't know.
We'll never know.
10-4 right. Dispatch, Rhymes and Jones on the case.
Oh, Mike, yes. I'm just going to click last use on this one. Okay. Now I'm playing as Rick Jones, a hardened veteran cop.
Of course, yeah.
And Mike's playing as John Rhymes, a hardened veteran cop.
Yeah. Yep.
I can't see a thing through these sunglasses, and I really want another Diet Coke, so I'll be right back. Don't start it off yet, Mike.
I already read the dispatch, though. We did the whole thing.
Fine. No, but Andy, a common misconception about high-stakes police calls like this, you can take your time. You don't need to get out there. It's like, if it's anything like San Francisco, they won't come for an hour, and then when they do show up, they won't do anything.
It's more like at our own convenience.
Really, it's more of a suggestion that we need the cops than it is a request.
Mike, I'm going to look for a plug-in for my mic so that I could talk to you and sound like a radio. Man, you're going at both of those donuts. You're double fisting the donuts. All right. Was not expecting that.
Man. I really like these donuts.
I don't know if you're going to make it to the next mission. I don't know if you're going to be able to go out there. You need to get crumbs all over the steering wheel, Mike.
Oh, man, dude. It's so crummy in here.
Yeah.
I don't let Jones drive because my steering wheel's so sticky, I'm embarrassed.
Oh, gotcha. Getting very personal. Anecdotes here from you, from your Rhymes. Or what's your name? Yeah, Rhymes.
See, he's just fucking eating donuts in silence. Oh, what did I miss? Jesus.
Kevin, I'm looking for a plug-in for my Elgato mic so I can make it sound like a little radio.
Oh.
Dispatch, come in. Dispatch.
Is that something you can add as a plugin? Is there a plugin store in the Elgato?
Kevin, there's no official plugin stores, but can download are any sort of plugins that do work. They are VST plugins, and I could get an equalizer and add a bunch of mids, drop the lows and the highs.
Kevin, what if I did it to mine? You ready for this? Let me do mine.
Oh, Mike, stop.
Kevin, this is Mike talking to you.
Kevin, check in. Is it changing it up?
He's pressing
all the buttons. It is. It's
I'm
wild.
Pressing all the buttons. This is Mike pressing buttons.
I forgot you had this.
Can you take the echo off, the first one off, and leave the second one off?
Take the echo off. Okay. And then I got reverb, I got pitch, and gender.
It sounds like you have reverb on right now.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I think you do.
No. Yeah, oh, my God. Stop.
Yeah,
I can't hear anything.
Can I hear the gender swap?
Of course, Kevin. I'll change the gender swap. Gender swap. And then gender swap. Gender swap.
Can you go,
swap
as deep
here.
As possible?
Is this deep?
Yeah. You're changing your voice.
No, you sound. Yeah, you sound normal. You can't change your voice, Mike. You can't change your voice.
Just changing your voice. Yeah.
How about this is Mike coming through the megaphone? This is Mike.
You should just talk normal, by the way. This is kind of ruining the magic for me.
How about this one? Beep, beep,
there
beep.
There
it is. There it is.
That's it.
That's the one I need.
What's that one?
No, but he's not using Wave. He's using like his own thing.
No, I know. Megaphone. So the Stream Deck store, it doesn't have any plugins for sounds that we could download?
Ooh. The Stream Deck has like... It sucks, Kevin. It's this thing where you download this thing called Voice Mod, and and I got the free subscription. It wouldn't let me unsubscribe, Kevin. I had to email them to unsubscribe.
Oh, it sucked. I had a kind of funny pay for it, and I used it for a while, remember?
It just doesn't seem very good.
It's fine. It's not great, you're right.
Wish it worked better, you know?
I did too.
Wish I could just drag and drop something, you know?
What are they again? The plugins for the Wavelink? Nick, calm down.
September 5th, 1998, 7:45. The city slums, Mike. Oh, I can't see shit. All right, here we go.
A badass drug table, if I do say so myself.
That's really cool. All
right, Lieutenant Ron's just still eating his donut.
Mike!
Andy Quez hasn't figured it out there.
Damn it, Mike. Where were you on that one, Mike? You were my partner. You were my brother, Mike.
Fuck.
Mike's trigger still has donut crumbs in it, Lieutenant Rhymes. So you're gonna have to.
Perfect. Okay, I got you.
Or Lieutenant Jones.
Mike, we got it. We're gonna. I forgot how to get to the freaking menu. Oh, I see. Never mind. Hold on. Let me scope this, Mike. Let me scope this.
Peep the sitch, bro.
Here we go. Oh, okay. All right. We got one guy in here, Mike. Ready? I'm gonna open the door. You're gonna.
Dude, I'm ready to peep this. Oh, you want me? Wait.
Yeah. Come on. You know
I don't have my taser. That means I'm putting bodies down,
Mike,
Rick.
Mike, you got a taser.
I'm putting
A,
bodies
Mike.
Down, Jones. Let's
you knew
go.
What you signed up for when you signed up for this mission. Ready?
Open the door. Breach.
3, 2, 1.
Clear.
Oh,
yeah,
so
you guys
slow.
Killed him.
So delayed.
All right, Mike, I got to scope. Oh, this guy is footsteps. Footsteps,
Mike.
Footsteps,
Mike.
Footsteps, Mike.
Footsteps. If he comes through here, we're about to
He's
ass.
Coming through. He's coming through. Boom. Wow. You guys are taking an approach for sure. Pick up the guns.
Hold on, I'm gonna pick this up. You gotta pick up the gun. Yeah, you got. Well, remember, Mike,
we're using a lot of unauthorized force. We're supposed to be bagging and tagging.
Hold on, I'm gonna do this. Hold on,
but that was unavoidable. Both of them would have fought you.
I forget the buttons.
I gotta get that. I forget. You think you got a melee?
Just shoot her. Oh, there you go.
There we go. I'm arrested.
Oh. Oh,
get down, protect yourself, lady!
Mike. God.
What happened to you, Jones?
Oh, no. Well, you restarted, Mike. I was still alive.
I didn't know you were alive. I didn't know. We got to be next to each other more. We got to get next to each other.
Also, we can only see Mike's feed, and it just cuts to black, so we should restart every time Mike
dies. Can spectate. He can hit F and spectate when I'm there.
Yeah.
He says he refuses to, though.
He's an asshole.
Weird.
All right, Mike, you gotta come with this guy. I got the taser.
You got the taser, Jones?
Yeah, I got a taser.
Let me open up this door. You ready?
Ready? Go.
Tase him.
Done. You just got
hit him? Put him down.
How do you run again? Okay.
Arrest him.
I just gotta arrest this guy. Now, Mike, it's up to you if you want to execute this guy. Fucking drug.
We keep
those points
so
high.
Good right now. Yeah.
Damn, I don't know where my. I thought I packed an SMG. I don't know why I still have this handgun.
I'm packed up. Packed up.
What do you think they were filming on this?
Do you want to walk? Do you want to walk outside and go and check out that window so you can see through there? No?
All right, here we go. Here we go, Mike.
Ready, Jones? I've got your back,
No
Jones.
One here.
Hold
on. No one here. Okay, let's proceed.
I'm going to eat another donut, Jones.
Eat another donut.
I think we have more pressing issues at hand.
Mike, I'm scoping.
So there is a guy in that room. We know that.
Okay, Mike, I need you to bust this guy's skull, but he's not armed as of yet.
Okay,
so get in there. Get in there.
These doors are very soundproof.
Mike, you punch me.
Hey, he's running. Get him. There it is.
We got him. He's locked in.
I'm pretty sure Mike just punched me right in the face.
And Andy, would you believe that they were getting like 100% by the end of the finish?
This guy right here?
I don't. Not the way this has started off.
They were
I got a breach charge. I'm going to breach charge this.
Oh, you want to breach that? Breach that.
It's not going to knock him out. He's too far.
Are you going to tase it, though? I got your back. I got your six, Jones.
I'm tasing. Wait.
Nice job. They're getting
so
in the
so
like
cool.
You guys
back,
are doing.
We're back on this.
Get this guy.
I'm gonna peep this bed. No, I got him. I'm going in. Got
her. To get down.
She's safe.
To get down.
She's safe now. She's safe.
All right. Hold on. Let me
we're
check.
Saving
let
civilians here.
Mike, I'm gonna scope your.
That's a half kitchen, half bathroom. That's a half kitchen, half bathroom.
I don't know if I can get the angle on this guy, Mike. You might
you
have to back me up on this.
Hold
on,
no.
We're gonna breach.
Mike, the bathroom's
we're gonna breach
not connected.
No, there's a toilet in there.
That's a toilet.
Yeah, there's a
toilet.
Wall. There's a wall right
Mike,
there.
Hold on, let me breach charge this kit. Ready?
Yep.
I don't know what wall you're talking one. About.
You telling me there's a stove and a toilet?
Oh, get him! Right.
Oh man, that's massive.
Sorry, huge. Right.
Dude, they got a poop. They got a pooper and
they got
a
shitter.
And a skillet, and they got
no
a.
No one should live that
top?
Way.
Mike, I mean, Kevin, the best way to live is to shit right where you eat.
Yeah,
that's what
yeah,
they
yeah,
say.
Yeah,
always
yeah,
shit
yeah,
where
yeah,
you
yeah.
eat.
Mm-hmm. We're going out. We're going out.
I don't know. Let's go back. Let's. You going that way? I'll go this way.
We're gonna wrap it. We're gonna. No, I'm sticking with you, Jonesy. I'm sticking with you, Jonesy.
Remember this guy too? There you
got that guy. Great job.
I'm the best fucking cop doc this world's ever seen.
Dude. I just stole even... some. I just stole some cocaine.
All right, I think you I might be almost out of taste.
Don't tell dispatch cocaine. About that. We got a bad guy. We got a bad guy.
I'm gonna flashbang out.
Dispatch, I heard all.
Oh, hold on! Oh no, Nick!
I just got killed.
Yeah.
Guys. All right.
He said
Mike, you know what to do.
Brutality after shooting someone.
Mike, you know what to do. You gotta. If I die, you gotta go straight to my house and make out with my wife. You're now her husband.
Oh. That's the law. Oh, they were doing pretty good for a while.
Dang it, I died.
Spectate.
Let's go to restart.
You died, everybody.
So, do we know how many levels are in this?
There's like six. Oh, we have like eight
this
more.
This is five, and then the next one is five as well.
What?
Five new
That's
ones and
awesome.
Five DLC zombie ones. So, we got a lot to do. We got
That's
a lot to do. A
lot
cool. of donuts
excited.
To eat as well. Anybody?
Now, Mike, I don't know why. You pull us out of this. Because for some reason, I don't have my, my...
Get
oh, this guy's coming. Fuck him. Good job, Mike. Fuck it. Hardcore mode, Mike.
Sorry,
let's go.
Okay, go.
Nobody lives to see them tomorrow.
They get in these hardcore moods.
Yeah, they stopped apprehending. They kind of just got bloodthirsty.
Yeah. I've been shot.
Take a banded.
Oh, God, man. Oh my God. Okay, restart.
All right.
We gotta
Let me
go back.
See. Go back to the equipment because I don't know why for some reason. I don't get.
Yeah, we gotta get back right, into our game. We gotta get back into what we do best.
Well, like, okay. Hold on. Because,
well, like, I wouldn't be able to tell you what it is you do best.
How come I only have three spots?
By what I just saw.
Alright, because usually I get. Where am I? Where's my taser gun? I get the taser gun out.
Yeah, it looks like they only let us have three spots now. I don't know if
I got
some reason.
I got five spots. What do you mean? You got five spots, bro?
I only have three on the bottom, though.
No, keep going.
Oh,
keep going.
I see. I gotta pack shit in there. Okay.
Hold on.
I don't want the flash gun. Do we like the flash? I don't need the grenade.
I got the flash grenades and a taser.
All right.
I'm gonna get the defibrillator in case you go down.
Yeah, give me the scope. I'm gonna scope it up.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but it's only let me.
I got a breaching kit and I got heavy armor.
Fill... It's only let me fill five spots or three spots.
I mean, I don't know what to tell you, Jonesy. You know, I mean, that's a dispatch question. That's not a mic question.
Fair enough. All right, cool.
I don't have the answers for that either.
No, I got donuts if you want more donuts, bro.
Mike, how many of those donuts are you going to eat before you think you can throw up?
I already had four.
No, Lieutenant Rhymes, Deputy Jones said that you don't ever drive his car because the steering wheel is real sticky.
Mike. Yeah, I screwed up. He doesn't let me have the whole kit. I only have three things now. Take us back.
You're a rookie.
Take us back.
You're a rookie.
I'm not a rookie. You're a fucking rookie.
Did you like connect to your old game?
Yeah, but look. So if you you can't see my mic. So if Mike goes to last used.
There we go.
I stopped streaming too.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
If Mike goes to last used, it has five spots. But I think maybe it doesn't let us have the five spots anymore.
It looks like Mike's last use has six spots.
What? You have six spots, Mike?
Yeah, Rick Jones is fucking loaded.
Loaded!
I'm not trying to make you feel bad about only having three spots.
I had six spots, but then I picked a new thing and I only have three spots. Hold on.
Hold on.
I just want the breaching thing. I just need to be able to scope. Gotta be able to scope. I don't need the armor. Cool. What is this? That's a flare. That's a taser. Cool. Daddy's ready to go. Let's go. Mike, we're winning this. This is for all the marbles.
Jonesy, I need you to lock in, bro. Okay, we should be done with this mission in the slums and be moving on.
Why the fuck is it not giving me my... Okay, there you go. Cool. Ready?
What you got? I got the taser ready.
I'm going to scope this guy. We're going to be surgical this time, Mike. There's no one in here.
Uh-huh. Nobody in? Break it in. Do it.
Go slow, fast. Slow is good.
Dispatch, room number one clear. Room one clear.
I'm going to scope the hallway. Mike, scope in the hallway.
Scope it.
Okay, hold on. I got no one in the hallway. No one in the hallway. Proceed with caution.
Clear. Watch your south. Watch your southbound. Oh, okay. You're taking shots. You're just taking shots.
The guy had a gun. Okay, oh, okay, watch your right.
I'll tase him. I'll tase my guy. I got a civilian that's decided to take shots at me.
Kill him.
I got him.
No.
I don't think you call them civilians if they take shots.
No, they're getting shot at you. Make sure you get a gun, Mike. We get extra.
You're kind of muddying the waters out there, Mike.
Yeah, there's no witnesses, Mike.
No, not, how do we scream, not get that
your hands
right
up?
Either.
I forgot how do you scream get your hands up, Mike?
Left bumper.
So this game, right now you all are in September 1998, one of the biggest movies at this time, Rush Hour.
Huge
Wow,
movie.
Rush Hour, yeah. Really? That's
guess what
epic.
The guess what the number one song is?
I don't want to miss a thing.
Oh, cool. Wow.
That was cool.
I want to close my eyes.
I'm going to flashbang around this corner.
Yep, flashbang it. Get in there.
Got a civilian on the far side. Bang.
Two civilians.
Get that.
Punch a lady
in
the
Mike.
I didn't mean to.
I got a pile of cocaine right here. Let's
looks like you
fun.
Meant to, Mike. It looks like you meant to.
I didn't mean to.
Mike, come over here with me. Let's clear out these rooms over here. Wow, this is a big building.
The number five song, Brandy and Monica, The Boy Is Mine.
Oh. Mike, get over here with your taser.
The boy is mine.
I'm sorry that you seem to be confused. She belongs to me.
That boy
is mine.
You going in?
All right,
that
Mike,
seems like a lot of guns in there.
Mike, you got your taser?
No more taser, but I can breach this thing.
Can you open this door?
Oh, yeah, you got it? All right, ready?
Yeah, open it up. Open up. There you go. Eat it, perp. Don't forget to pick up the guns, Mike. We get the extra credit for that. Oh, there's a lot of guns in here, Mike. We could sell these. Retired or Reno.
Oh, man. That would be so
How
great.
Much money do you think you need to be able to retire to Reno and just live like a king, Mike?
It's more and more every year, man.
300,000 max.
Yeah, Mike has no idea how money works. No offense, Mike.
300,000 max. I look at, as you can tell, Kev, because he's got a max on how much money he needs.
Max.
And not a dime more, he said.
Let me scope this. Okay, this room looks clear.
Clear it out. Dispatch, main bedroom's clear. Found cocaine on the bed.
Goldfish in my room right now, thank you.
10-4, dispatch. You ready?
All right, I don't have any tasers left. I got
ready,
one.
Jonesy?
Hold on. I'm gonna flash.
I got a little. You got a flashbang? You ready to flashbang that thing?
Go.
Flashbang it.
Close the door.
Great job.
No one in here? Just cocaine.
More cocaine.
Just cocaine. This guy, we're missing one person here.
Flashbang.
Got one guy left?
I think so. Let's see. Let's go around. Let's be surgical.
Jones and Rhymes, I've been keeping track of every time you mentioned.
Oh, we got gunshots.
Hold on.
We got gunspots. We got gunshots. He shot me. Can you defend me? Can you defend me?
I got no defense, but I think I can win.
Okay, LB. Win it out.
Speculate.
I'm trying. I'm pressing all the buttons.
LB, yes, LB.
I am pressing all the buttons.
I don't have a defib, Mike.
There we go. I got him. I'm finished off my fourth donut.
Hold on. I don't have a defib because, again, I only have three spots. I apologize, Mike. I'm going to scope you. I'm going to give you a colonoscopy right now.
No, that sounds really... That's not good, Nick.
I've kept track of every time you mentioned you found cocaine, so keep that in mind.
You're keeping track of that? You fucking
keeping count. So when you get back, I expect to see that many amount. Of,
okay, how many was it? No, so I know. Just so I know.
Four.
Was it four?
Yeah.
You're certain about this?
Shit, maybe I got the number wrong.
Eat it. Oh shit, there's a guy right there. Here we go. Last one, Kevin. Breathe, Kevin, for me. There it is.
Great job, Jonesy. You still got a lot of area to clear, though.
Jesus, do I really?
Yeah, I'm just top right.
I really wish I had a partner
right
now.
A little northeast. You're going to have to go northeast, Jonesy.
I might be out of ammo.
Such a Jonesy thing to do.
I think we cleared it.
Nope, Jonesy. Oh!
No, he got me with my guy.
Bruh. Got to go in again. Dispatch is really disappointed in us right now.
Dispatch, how many cocaines did we need?
You found four cocaines.
How many cocaines do we need?
Mike, right here, tase this guy.
I'm gonna
or breach
that
charge.
Man.
You want to breach charge a guy?
Nah, I'll tase him.
Ready? Ready? Go.
Got him.
Rush in.
Got him. Put him down. Lock him up. Lock him away.
Here we go.
Lock him away.
I like how you moved him over to the corner. That was a pro move, Mike.
Yeah, I like you're to move him out cool of our
cop
way.
Mike, you're such a cool cop.
I mean, right, Rhymes no is a cool cop.
Doc,
but... All right, Mike, we're going to go right across here.
I'm ready.
Let's go up this room.
Clear.
They don't know we're
south
here
side
yet.
Clear. South side's clear.
They don't know we're here yet.
Get into the mud room. Get into the mud room, Jonesy. Uh-oh.
Get into the room with the toilet in the kitchen.
Mixed up. Mike, there's a guy right in front of me. You got
to
pay him.
I'm ready. I'm ready to shoot him.
Ready? Go.
An awful setup, Andy. You know what I mean? Oh, he's
beat it down. Beat it down. Beat it down. Nice job, Jonesy. Nice job, Jonesy.
Hey, you got it.
I forgot I had melee. All right, Mike. Hold on. We got to. Mike, get that door closed behind us. Watch our six.
Letting them know. Let me know if I need to breach charge.
You might have to breach charge. Oh, we got a civilian right here.
A civilian? Okay, you got that? Handle that?
Hold on. I might have to taser.
No force.
Oh, I tased her.
Oh, God.
There was no reason to do that. She's going to sue us. And honestly, she deserves to win. There was no reason to tase that part.
Right? That's the only way to handle that situation.
Well, good, Jonesy. Nice job, Jonesy. What was that all noise? Right. Be careful of the doorway. I'm going to breach charge this man.
Hold on. Let me look.
He's coming. Shit, Mike. There was a guy. Oh. You're right. You did it right. I got you, Brody.
You see that guy come out of nowhere, Kevin?
Mm-hmm.
It's cheating. That guy was cheating, Andy.
Dispatch, I got a problem. My partner's down, dispatch.
Does the partner know that this room's been laid out the same way the past four times?
Uh-huh. Hey, they change it up. It's a procedural thing.
Mm. Oh! Yeah. I've been shot. I repeat, I have been shot, but I'm still up. I'm going to defib my partner, Jonesy.
Can you defib me?
Come back to life.
Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Throw some cocaine in his face.
Throw a little cocaine at me.
Wake right up.
Got him.
Oh my God, I'm up. I'm up.
He's
and
back.
I'm beautiful.
He's back. We're back again.
I'm going guns hot for everything from now on.
Whoa.
Lady,
whoa,
what'd you say?
Jonesy.
What'd you say, lady? Okay.
I'm out of tasers. Oh, we're going guns hot. I repeat. Dispatch, we've gone guns hot.
Now, are you only going guns hot because you ran out of tasers?
Yes, correct. They only give us 3 tasers, Andy. Yeah, breach this right here.
Yeah, I don't know.
Why am I breaching that this time?
It's fun. Hey, it's fun for me.
I don't know if officers should be working on how much ammo they have left. I think at that point, maybe you, like, all I got is rocket launchers. This is what I got to use.
We're loud. We're very loud.
Oh, God damn it. Mike, you did it right. Defend me, Mike.
Rhymes, you got another officer down, Ryan.
I've been shot by a fake civilian. Fake civilian.
Damn it. That's why you guys just got to kill everyone.
No, we got to figure out your inventory slot issues.
Yeah, I don't know why I don't have this extra slot. Whatever. Maybe they'll give it to me after this. Andy, this game is deceivingly hard to play.
This feels like the first time we played this.
Don't sit there and try to say like you would do better at this by concentrating and being a better gamer, because you don't know how hard this is to have this much fun with your friend.
Very well said, Nicholas. Very well said.
Thank you. Okay, Mike. We're gonna lock in right now, Mike. We're gonna do it this time. Slow is fast.
Man, his music's banging though.
Okay, right in front of me, Mike. Tase out.
Ready. I'm ready. Tase up. Oh!
God, that was beautiful.
The fuck up.
That's just like they teach us in the
He's
academy.
He's been tased. There we go. You could have told her to get down, but you slapped her.
I don't know how to do it. I forgot how to do it. I think I just tased you in the butt, Mike. I'm sorry.
She might have shot me.
I apologize. Hold on. Let me scope. Scope it in first.
Lieutenant Jones has been shot.
Clear. Clear. Bedroom clear.
There's a guy in here.
Okay. Got him?
Got him.
Nice job.
Tased, bro.
Setting up the
Tased
breach and charge.
Tased the rainbow. Tased
We're
the
going
rainbow
into the bedroom. We're going into the bedroom kitchen. The bedroom kitchen.
Go.
Break in.
I love Force and Neft here. I come back after a meeting and they're in cop doc uniforms. Nailed it. That is
Hold on,
cop
Mike,
doc.
Let's go.
There's
Mike,
no
let's go.
Signs of doc in there. But
Mike, right here.
He's there.
I'm gonna try. Don't let her get away.
She was trying to get out of here. Little does she know we're gonna take her to safety.
Yeah, she
is.
The
very opposite of doc is happening here.
Uh-huh. I can get my doctor outfit on at any moment as well.
Okay, Mike, right here.
Did you bring it home?
This guy?
That's a deep one.
Got the on that guy?
Oh yeah, Kevin, 100%.
I was looking at mine the other day.
You got that guy?
We got
him. Nice shot, bro.
Oh man, that was incredible.
Got him. That was a great shot. That's a great shot.
Kid on the bottom.
Mike, there might be some fun stuff right here.
Shoot him. Yep.
So I'm not going to say dispatch. We have cocaine. Yeah, don't tell us dispatch because dispatch is a fucking party pooper.
Whatever you've been calling cocaine fun stuff for the last 20 years.
Fun powder has been found, everyone. We need a little sweet and low for the coffee.
Behind you.
Know what I'm talking about.
Mike, behind you.
We got some silly snow over here.
Oh, shit. I'm at it.
Gone loud. He's gone loud. Dispatch, we've gone loud. We've gone hot.
Lieutenant Jones, I'm not surprised.
Mike, there's another table of... Oh, shit! Oh, shit!
How did that echo?
Dispatch, officer down, dispatch.
I said it twice.
You said it twice.
Oh,
very similarly, yeah.
Yeah, that was really well done, Nicholas.
Guys,
yeah.
I'm good at VO work.
Dispatch, do we know where... Oh! Clear.
Couple missed shots there.
Dispatch, where is my partner?
I'm right outside that door. By the fun powder.
Dispatch, no fun powder. No fun powder to be found, dispatch.
Mike, I'm gonna need you to take me to Vegas after this.
Clear.
All right, thank you for the defib. Let's go slow. We only got a couple rooms left. Is this a bomb we gotta defuse?
Negative.
Nope, guy right there.
Got
Good
him.
Job, Mike.
Andy, they were getting S.
We got bad guys,
scores.
Bad guys.
Like perfect runs.
Woo!
And it wasn't
Do you keep
even
saying
that
this, Kevin? I don't believe it.
But it wasn't even that they had memorized the thing. They would go in.
No, we just
first
got really.
Again.
We locked
they
in.
Got re- they knew all the buttons.
Take him down. Take him down, Jonesy.
Yeah, sorry. Oh, I knew you had a gun, bro.
Good clear out,
See,
Jonesy.
He was hiding it, Andy. We didn't know if he had a gun or not, but I had an instinct from all the years of me being a cop doc.
Oh, shit. Oh, I gotta stop talking.
Oh, man. Mike, can you give me the thing? Can you give me the thing again?
I already gave you the sweet juice. You only get one. You only get one.
All right, finish this up. Let's go to the next level. Nice,
no,
Mike.
We did it.
Nice, Mike. Congratulations.
Clear.
You're a lieutenant now. What did we get? We failed. We got an F.
You got a great F.
You're surprised by that. There's like, sounds like there's shock.
Well, I mean, we got a couple good things going on.
One of you died.
Could have got a C. Wow. I mean, that's...
You kept shooting just random people.
They looked at me funny, and they might have had a gun, and some of them did. So,
No, that's true.
Should we? You want to try that again, Mike, or are we moving on to the next one?
Move on to the next one.
What was that?
Which number donut is that? Donuts, rather. There's two
Mike,
there.
Are you douching two donuts at the same time?
Mike, you gotta understand that if you stack them on top of each other, it doesn't make it just one donut. They are stacked up too.
It's one double stacked donut.
You're gonna feel awful in the next hour.
All right,
Andy, we're gonna need some people to help read these, so I would like you to be the suspect. And then,
what do you want? Find something or what?
Kevin, you're the next thing. Oh, that's Mike. Mike, go.
I think there's enough stuff to charge for illegal gun possession here, Rick. A few lifetimes for the whole neighborhood.
Wait, let's make a deal. We haven't had a chance to sell any of the crates anyway. But you'd know what to do with this stuff, right?
It's like I'm they sure came the whole thing on the thing.
I'm sure you'll find a buyer and make a fortune off of this, officers.
This guy's made a good point.
Oh. So you were gonna sell all of this. Thank you for your honest confession. Trick
him, Mike.
You want a bribe?
The hell do you need from me then? Just when I got a chance to move up in this godforsaken place. Please, just tell me what you want.
How come I don't have any lies in this?
Tell me where the guns came from. Who gave them to you? Did you buy them? Or were they a present?
John, enough of this. Let me handle him.
I have that info that you need. I mean, I don't really know who sold the guns, but...
This guy's like, arg.
But I know where they came from. Yes. I'll give you the address of the warehouse I got them from.
Good.
Man, this guy waffles a lot.
This guy's not really consistent.
That's a good start. Nice doing business with you. Although, I lied.
What? So I'm free to go?
Yeah, you're going to jail.
I never said we had a deal.
John, the weapons are marked. Stone and Roberts, I think we have a lead on yesterday's events.
This is nonsense.
Yeah. My first day on the job, and it was a very memorable one.
That was a crazy
first,
day.
We had a fight with those bikers at the bar. Oh, he's just reminiscing about the original
this
game.
This is a previously on. Yeah, this is a previously on.
Then, the gun warehouse situation, and ending with the assassination attempt on a movie director?
You forgot about the bomb at the studio.
And I'm just sitting there like, man, this is crazy.
You guys had a great day.
Like, cool story.
Oh, right. And that was just the single vacation. Day.
All right.
Damn.
They reminisced with a guy just sitting there. That's incredible.
All right, dispatch. What do we got for us?
We got your report on the impromptu interrogation. No luck identifying the supplier, but we now have the address of the warehouse where the guns originated. Looks like we got a CSE building up. A case building up.
Case. I think it's case.
I think it's case.
According to the documents, the warehouse has been long been abandoned. But the trucks keep coming in and out. Don't be surprised.
I like to believe there's a world in the cop world where case is abbreviated to CSA.
Don't be surprised if you get a warm welcome. Good luck.
Good luck.
Oh, look, they put a period after the final word there.
Oh, that's pretty smart.
I feel like it's like a game that like me and Nick wrote, you know? Look, guys, nobody double-checked.
It's a small dev team, okay? And spelling is hard sometimes. Let's get into this, Mike. What's my question?
I was like, weird that they didn't like capitalize CSE. Like, that's got to stand for something. Criminal scene, you know, eradication or something.
All right, I'm going to swap out this flash grenade for something else.
Yeah, swap out the flash grenade? Okay,
what
I like
that.
What
do you think that. I should do for? A med kit, maybe, in case you get shot?
Yeah, that's a defib if you want to pick me back up, big dog.
Okay, let's do the defib here.
I'm going to switch over to a shotgun.
I'm liking my long ranger here, though.
Are you still stuck at three spots?
Yeah, it's weird. I don't
that's
know why.
A bummer.
I know, it sucks.
Now, whatever. You're sure you loaded your old game? Because you start with three slots.
I started with six, and then
so
I went,
why don't you just restart and connect again? Because, I mean, like, I feel like you're playing very different with limited spots, mm-hmm. and it makes
let's
sense.
Try, let's try it.
Man. I also get the feeling that Kevin really wants me to believe that y'all are good at this game.
At one point, we might have been.
I don't care if you believe me or not. It was, I mean, you could watch the tapes.
I feel like Kevin sold me a bill that I was, you know, going to watch him elite game plan so far. I'm not seeing it.
Oh,
Mike, right here.
Dispatch, we're outside the CSE.
Onto the CSE.
Great job, Jonesy.
All right, here we go. Coming through. Scoping the door. Mike.
I got that good stuff. I got that good.
Drink the juice, lay on your side. We're gonna have to go through this one by one. There might be guys in here.
Okay, one by one.
Oh, there's a guy right here.
Handle that guy. Handle him. Put your hands up. Oh my god! He just danced on us.
Nick is just punching from 12 feet away.
Good job, Mike. Good job.
Clear.
Bathroom's clear. Bathroom's clear. Fast as smooth.
I'm putting bodies in the bathroom. We're clear.
Just scooching bodies into the bathroom. I love
That's
it.
That's really good.
That's smart. Oh, look at this guy, Mike.
I'm ready.
What does this guy think he is? Ready?
I'm ready to get that guy.
You ready? I'm going to come over here. Open this up. Ready?
Got him.
Good shoot.
Look at that. He had a machine gun on him.
All right, Mike. Scoping it again.
Scope it, Jonesy.
All right. Oh, we got a civilian over in the corner, Mike. She may or may not have a gun. You're going to have to check her purse. All right, ready?
I'm ready. Nice.
Good.
We're going into the DJ studio, dispatch.
DJ High Tech. Screw up me on the motherfucking beat now. Pickety. Oh, Mike, right here. You got a taser for this guy?
I'm ready.
I'd like to introduce you guys to this map.
I just could just imagine the criminals on the other side hearing Nick doing techno sounds.
I'm a DJ.
Like, you just hear, like, the other side of the wall, like... He's like, what the fuck's happening out there?
I think I just got busted by Antward.
Jonesy, go to the other side. Jonesy, go to the other door. Give me a scope. I'll get a breach on this charge. I'll get a breach charge ready.
Hold on. All right, hold on. Ready? We're gonna check this out. We're gonna
do this together. It's a big area. It's a big room.
Huge area. Okay. We're gonna go all the way over here. I don't see anyone in this area at all.
On the far side, you're not getting the scan on the far side. I'm getting the scan on the far side.
I can't see
that
far on my thing, but I think you're okay. Don't waste the breach over there. Come in here with me.
All right. Grimes is on the move.
Oh, I see a guy here. Hold on.
Damn, you got him. That's a big shot. That's a deep shot. You got that? Go get him.
I got to reload the taser first because that apparently is more important.
Only shoot if you have the shot.
Thank you, dispatch. Oh shit.
Clear.
Okay, we got guys here. Mike, you're getting ahead of
him. I got him.
See, he does this. This is what happens. He goes all rogue.
To be fair, you both do this a lot.
Nice job, Jonesy.
Facing the wall with a baseball bat, thinking about the days that used to be better. Guys, we have a little bit of a fun powder here. A little fun powder found.
That's cocaine. Noted.
It's fun. And no.
Mike?
No cane.
Yes, no cane. Yes, dispatch.
And that is, we are at time.
We are at time.
All right, we're going to finish this level. We're going to beat this level straight away. Mike, uh-huh. Mike, slow down. Slow down, Mike. Not too fast. You're moving
Remember,
too fast.
Twitch chat, if we fill up this bar at this last moment, I will stream some Zelda Breath of the Wild right after this as well if you want it.
Right here. Right, this guy right here. You got a taser left?
Yeah, I got a taser.
All right, we're going to tase this guy right here. You got the beat on him? Yep. Turn the beat around. Oh, I told you to tase him.
Not his ass.
Lieutenant Rhymes, that's a good song.
Thank you.
Oh, shit. Well, I thought I had my taser out.
Good? You good?
Well, we're not going to get an A for this mission. Let's just put it that way.
All right, we've gone guns hot.
We had to go guns hot. She ran at me. I almost hit it with the
defibrillator. Got a defib out? You got a defib out?
I don't know my weapons.
I'm ready to throw out a flashbang.
Open it, I'll flash it.
Open it, I'll flash it. Close the door. I'm going in. We got a bad guy dead ahead of us in armor. Nice job.
Jesus.
Oh, Mike.
Yeah, man.
Boomstick. Hold on, let me get this.
Absolutely pop that, man.
Oh, my.
Oh.
No!
No!
Rhymes and Jones. Come in, Rhymes and Jones. 10 gifted tiles from Soul Porpoise.
Officer down. And that is the end of the stream. Thank you to Soul Porpoise. For the 10 gifted subs. So thank you close. For anybody for tuning in. It's been a fun Monday stream. It's been nice to catch up with the gang and have a ton of fun as always. Thank you to Andy and Kevin for being our dispatchers of the day. And thank you to Nick for getting our fun uniforms to wear for this stream. Of course, we love police stories. We're big fans of the game. If you're looking for a hotline Miami-esque game, this is a very fun one. But guess what, everybody? We'll see you back here tomorrow for a Pros versus Joes Returnal run. Goodbye, everyone.